Ladies and gentlemen, if you could move as close to the front as you can, let's let everyone in here.
Oh yeah, because you know what it's time for. We are 13 what? Years old. We are hormonal, spotty.
Excuse me, we got some young people here. Yeah, you're being quite insulting, actually.
Oh yeah, we do actually have, but we don't have any 13-year-olds, so do we? But this year, Poets vs MCs is 13 years old, and we have got a lineup of major awesomeness.
That sounds quite shit when you put it like that, actually, to be fair. And yeah. Can you give it its proper title? It's Poets vs Masters of Ceremony! Woo! Team Rep!
Yeah, I had the same response in my mind as you guys did in real life. But at least he tried and he's enthusiastic from the start, so that's good. Before I start slurring his words later on, because it is his birthday. That's right. So he needs all the love. Well, he doesn't even need it, he just deserves it. But well, enough of that. Yeah, I know. What am I doing? I'm forgetting that we're on opposing teams. We have got, as normal, what's coming up?
Well, have you been to the Poets vs MCs before? Make some noise, please. Who hasn't? Okay, we're going to have to explain some things then. Rosie, take it away.
Okay, so we've got two rounds with a cypher in the middle. So the first round is just a showcase round where all the poets and all the rappers are just going to come to the stage, do a quick piece, and then bugger off again. The rappers this year have got, so normally then the poets and rappers will come back in the second half and do a battle. Don't take me wrong, that is still happening this year. But the rappers are going to mix it up a bit in between the rounds.
Well, we're going to have a little cypher in the middle to be, because basically this thing is kind of, we're lowering ourselves to a poetry format. So, you know what I mean? So we're gonna get some beats on the go. We're going to have a little rap. So any rapper out there is welcome to get on stage. When that happens, you'll have clues. But I've also brought a gang of my young trainees, my Padawans. So keep an eye out for them. I'm sure they've handed you an audio active flyer. If they haven't, they're going to get beaten.
Yep. So if you want to get involved in that, come up when the time comes, like Tom says. And in the meantime, I reckon we should crack the bejesus on with this. So we are going to go poet, rapper, giving up some posy. And which amazing, fantastically dressed poet do you think is going to go first?
Jessica Rabbit.
Oh, yeah.
The first act this evening is Rosie Carrick. Make some noise.
That's good. I mean, it was good of Tom, but not that good of you, if I'm honest. I'm just going to stick this in its little hole. And I'm going to read you a poem that solves all these universal questions, which is, why are there no grown-ups who have holes in their heart like they always do when you're in primary school and someone's like, yeah, well, I was actually born with a hole in my heart. Although, bizarrely, recently I did hear from my upstairs neighbour about someone who is a grown-up who has a hole in their heart and they on the brink of death. So I take it all back. It still happens. People can die from it. And I hope that neighbour isn't here today. But for art, I think it's fine. So this is a poem called Heart. Look, we all know you were born with a hole in your heart, and that when the doctor sewed it closed, she lost her hair from her head across the top of your aorta, and so now you dream of her childhood every night, but that's no excuse for cutting away from your family and quitting your job. You eat like an animal. All this meat, every morning for breakfast. You can't grow a second heart, you know. By twicing the scope of your skin, there's now a graveyard of pig's ears in pet shops whose body bits got hacked off on your account, and it wasn't like this 10 years ago. When you bring up the hair over dinner, this magical, endlessly static, non-disintegrating hair, and your plans to have it CAT scanned and removed so you can stop feeling guilty for never going to visit her brother's ashes. I can see the faces of couples at neighboring tables, rolling their eyes uncomfortably into their soup as you spit grease across the tablecloth in your passion, their scorn aimed always at me for humouring this nonsense, as though even to be in your company and not be trying to shut you up is a form of neglect in the face of your clear psychosis. When the months pile up wrongly, and I fall back on the tracks of that terrific low where everything's more like the smear of crushed slug on escalator grey than a bucket full of endless hot chocolate and TV, you lose sight of me in the face of her difficult days at school and how her father never called her back when he said that he would do, and I buy into it. Playing along in the part of her best friend, I talk to you sleeping, and you are clearly so beside yourself to speak to me. Then in clumsy, muttered REM conversation, you squeeze my hand like a treadling cat, and when you cry through your lashes, terrified of these recurring dreams you get of being an aging fat man with a wife whose arms are covered in snail trail scars, I reassure you that those people have never existed. And stroke tidy your flailing eyebrows as we thicken the string of our future plans for the pictures on the walls of the bagel shop we're going to open together as soon as we've grown up. Thank you.
Make some noise, please. I'm sorry we started with a poem. It's a bit of... doesn't really kind of get you that into it, does it? But it's a bit like watching a trailer and it's just like wistful looks. I just thought, yeah, man. Oh, you have a prop. Basically, we weren't allowed to bring beats. I'm not going to have any beats. So the first guy, while he said, so this is my man, Marissa. He's known as Shroud. Make some noise, please. Extra props, because he's the godfather of my child, too. Give him a cheer for that, please. The best man for the job. So what are you going to do, Marissa? Go and get some shit?
I'm going to do a little poem for you, but I also have a prop. It's called a keyboard, in case you hadn't already have guessed. While I'm setting up, I'll just explain. The keyboard for me, I don't know if any of you in here play instruments. Any of you in here play instruments? Right? So, your instrument, if you've been playing it since you were a kid, is like your little brother or your little sister. But I have two. One of them is the instrument, the other one is rap. So today, you know, they haven't really spent much time together because they have different mums. But today I'm gonna introduce them to you for the first time on stage on my own. So. We're rebels without a cause, trying to bubble in kettles without the cords. Dudes are locked in kennels without the pause, trying to move forward and pedal without a course. We revel in wanting more, telling them what's in store, you never cannot be sure. Cause if you ain't, then it's bad luck. Stand up, it's a motto or a mantra. Sangro, be lost in your main goal. Sweat and tears will be dropped in the same bowl. The recipe is old to go and make gold. Try your best so the death doesn't take hold. Make mold for yourself in the grey holes, in pyramids which they give to a great soul. Nowadays you will slave for a payroll. So life ain't for free, you gotta pay toll. We just need to stand up strong. Be at peace and stand up. To the man and his minions, who cannot stand your opinions. In his land and his kingdom, you're not a man and civilians don't have a plan or an inkling of what they're thinking. We're just sinking into the river Styx, in the city mix, where the vision isn't pretty but the picture is. So we snap it up and lap it up, trying to find the peace in the land above. A passenger, saddle up, cause a lot of people travel rough. Some will ask if you're man enough, or can you handle the madder stuff. 1 minute is colder than Canada, then it's hot like you're over in Panama. So brace yourselves and get ready for what is next. Make yourself be quick. witted and watch a step. We just need to stand up strong. Be at peace and stand up strong. Where the sea and the land belongs. We just need to stand up strong. Clap for me, guys. Yeah. No, 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 I don't mean like that. I'm in rhythm, go.
No wins.
That's it, tap, back. Chorus. Yeah. When I go, we just need to, you say, stand up strong, right? So I want you to guys to do it. So, we just need to stand up strong, be at peace, and how we do, man? Where the sea and the land belongs. We just need to stand up strong.
For any audience participation. I was already feeling queasy. You forget, one forgets that we're not in the battle round, and that also I love Marisi, but also I do promise that I never asked her. I'd never come at you.
It's not mutual.
Yeah, okay, that's good. That's good. Keep it going. This does sound like an increasingly better offer, so we'll talk about it later backstage. Okay, we have got a poet now, okay? We have gone from poetry to kind of jazz rap, I think. Is that a subgenre of rap? Jazz rap. And now we are going to go for the completely insane, the perfect, the wild, the man that is Chris Parkinson!
Evening. I'm going to read you a poem in a moment. I sing in maybe less than 1% of it. And for that I apologise in advance. It's mostly about seals. This is called Find and Replace. Increasingly, over the past year, or perhaps longer, my life has become what I can only describe as a parade of anthropomorphic seals. Now, I've always liked seals, although I don't think they make it into my top five favourite animals. You can't not have a soft spot for a seal. If you go to Norfolk, you can go on a boat ride and see them lolling on the beach at Blakeney Point. Yay! Seals look more comfortable than I do when I'm trying to sleep. They can lie comfortably on their backs, on their fronts and on their sides. And although until recently I didn't think you could tell the mood of an animal by the expression on its face, which is why everyone thinks dolphins are happy all the time and tuna don't have a discernible emotion within them, which is not the case, but that is a story for another day. But these seals on the beach at Blakeney Point look happy, and who am I to begrudge a seal happiness? Even if it's just the fact that their faces look like they are having a good time, if you have ever given a seal some bad news, you will notice that the face does not alter in any notable manner. Yet in the past month, the seals have worked their way into everything I do. At first it was just Calypso songs and the second test and the seal won. But now there are intricate sketches in my notebook about how a seal could possibly play cricket and win a match at Lord's. It is notable that it is a single seal at one, which is unusual in cricket, and offers no indication that Victoria's team was either comprised entirely of seals or even had any other members except for the seal. Although there is a cricketer called Weddle, which I can only assume refers to the Weddle seal, which is the most northern of all the seals. And when sitting down to watch some of my favourite items of American TV, there are now seals in it. For the entire first season of True Detective, I was convinced that the murderer would be the man with the face of a seal who appeared in several scenes, and whom I am now informed does not appear to have a seal face to most other viewers of the show. Let alone the logical issues as to how a man would have a seal face, and where the seal face ends and the human begins. And in fact now, when I speak to my wife, she often has to ask if I'm talking to her or to the seal. And the worst thing is that I often have to check and rerun conversations back through my head, because I'm certain some of them were actually with the seal. And then I read on the internet the story of someone who has found a seal egg on a beach, and they have taken the seal egg home to incubate it and hatch a baby seal. And this makes me rethink what seals are, because I've not possibly imagined before that they could even at all hatch out of eggs. And I look on Twitter and I have a message from someone who was standing for election in Hove, which is not even a constituency I live in, and they tell me they are very fond of seals, and I wonder how they know and if I've messaged them at some point. But when I search for seals on the internet, half of the results are about the musician called Seal from the 90s who released Kiss by a Rose, which can cause confusions about how he attacked a scientist in the Arctic or performed an indecent act involving a penguin. And I am just trying to write poetry that is interesting and satirical and that has a story somewhere in it. And I think that perhaps the seal is a metaphor that has taken on a life of its own and explains how difficult it is to live in a world that is so interconnected. But if this is the case, why are they sending me messages and finding their way into every aspect of my life? And suddenly, I find both seals and the modern world are very confusing things. And perhaps I should go to Blakeney Point myself and lie down on my back, on my front, on my side, and feel the warmth of the sun. And there will be a look on my face that the seals, not knowing you cannot tell the mood of someone from their expression, would consider to be happy.
Make some noise, please! Seals. Marine life. He also wrote that famous hoax that got the film Tusk made, so you can see his daily thoughts are actually being presented to you there. That is a fact. The next guy we got coming up, our name is Rory, but for some reason he's called Lolly. He's called Lolly! Maybe that means that you suck. I don't know what it means. But Lolly, make some noise, please!
Yo, happy birthday to my man Tom Hines here, yeah? This is a bit of a poem, bit of hip-hop thing. It's dedicated to all of you. It's about crushing negativity with positivity in this cold, cruel, sick, disgusting world. Make some noise one more time. Come on, get a bit live in here, yeah? Can you hear, yeah? Fuck. Didn't realize there were that many people here. Anyway. Everyone always accuses me of being cynical. I have wholehearted hippie jimmy friends that love to be spiritual. They influence me to keep my head up and avoid thoughts that are miserable. And they're the reason why I keep believing in miracles. But it's not that I feel scars and wounds can't be healed. It's not that I like being negative, I just prefer to be real. Tripping with life in happiness and witnessing a massive difference. In this cold, cruel world, you have to seek peace within a distance. Cause I portray a vision where ambition is driven by talent we're given, as all beauty in mankind is existing where we be living. But with all the torture and slaughter and the typical criminals, how can one blame another for being depressed, especially cynical? You've got to face the hard times to get to the good ones, I gather that. Looking forwards, not backwards, through these chapters we grow stronger. These learning experiences where the answers are dangerous. With all the bodies in the world, the competition is outrageous. The abundance of hundreds of faces that want to be famous. The paedophiles, child molesters, arsonists and rapists. The muggers, the murderers, the racists, the haters. The gangs, the terrors, the dictators. The politics, the rulers, the greed that makes us starve, suffer and be contagious. The liars, the snakes that manipulate and play us. Sometimes you wonder, God, why did you even bother to create us? With all these wastes of spaces, can you feel my frustration in this land we share with monsters that tear up our nature? So before you point the finger at me and judge me for being cynical, actually take into account his standard words, his common sense, as my eloquence is lyrical. There are wonderful human beings that dedicate their lives for others and our environment. They try to prevent our planet from folding into early retirement. And to all elegant species looking down from up above, for those conserving our homes, I give back bare love. Because being pessimistic is realistic. It sounds crazy, let alone insanity. Enforcing hate in all of reality is heartbreaking in all of humanity. So yes, by being down to earth, I let cynicism get the best of me. But I also discover and educate, because that's what should really be our destiny. I have dreams that I believe we can all achieve as we can all travel far. As long as you all remember to appreciate yourself for who you really are. So forgive me again for being cynical, but with my history involving Judas, it's both psychological and physical. Because it feels like life is a constant roller coaster, a cycle of pain. But there are those moments where you earn to get back that big break. That gives me the pat on the back and makes me stay. And I mean no disrespect, I love all my friends to death. But because of schemers, I'll never trust anyone 100%. Whether it be my whirly heads or even gypsy disco crew, not even my London homeboys and sisters, the ones that are missing are gone. Crossman, I still pray for you. Not even my Candela or Project Nine brothers, not even my own family or even my own mother. Cause sure, it's easy to not let go of the horror stories. That's when you get hurt. But the more you think of those nightmares, the more the flashbacks return. So when you then think of the good ones, notice that's when you're able to recover. Then ask yourself this question. How do I create more of those memories to once again see the beautiful colors? I don't mean to preach and be emotional, it's just who I am. Worshipping a god that's a genius on drugs, what's a hollow in my hands? Unlike most, you can feel the realness in my blood even when you shake my fucking hand. Cause I speak the truth from a root. When I write, I've got to have a purpose. And to let out my passion when I'm screaming, it's urgent. And for that, I don't gas. I mean what I say and I'm certain. And that's why my real friends and family connect with me. Because just like you, Jeff, I'm a real fucking person. Zev. Big up to John Clark and the rest who let me do this, man. Appreciate it.
Lolly! That's Lolly with one L, if you're writing it down. You don't want to offend anybody. Next up, we have got a guy who smashed it big style here last year, so he's back again. He was a regular at Hammer and Tongue, he won the slam final last year, and he is here tonight. He's the reverse father of John Clark. Can you please welcome to the stage, Michael Clark!
Hello, how are we all doing? Oh, I'm glad to hear it. So I thought I'd wear this turtleneck tonight to help, smash the stereotype that we're all here to smash stereotypes tonight, because, you know, some of us are just here desperately seeking validation. I know I am. So to try and tease that validation out of you, ladies and gentlemen, I've written some haikus. Yeah, especially for you. For the uninitiated, haikus are sort of short 17-syllable poems, often 5-7-5 structure, and they're meant as sort of fleeting philosophical observations of nature. So I've written some to address these said subjects, and I've shuffled them up in a random order, and we're going to have a random lighting display for each haiku, and we're all going to experience sort of jazz-infused chance procedure once in a lifetime experience. You up for that? All right. I must warn you though, there's some real fucking heavy shit in these haikus. So, quite rock and roll stuff. So, can I get a kind of we will rock you like. Oh, fuck it. Like, you know what I'm talking about. Like a boom, tch, boom, boom, tch, boom, tch, boom, boom, tch. All of you. People at the back, don't take no slack. Yeah, okay. Philosophical haikus, here we go. Freud slipped. Hurt his back. It was on a banana. He called for his mum. Poor René Descartes. He got shit Christmas presents. It's the thought that counts. Maybe. If France is bacon, then Germany is hash brown. No? Who is Hungary? Huh? It's just language, play with it. Are you a man or a mouse? Mickey Mouse was unable to respond. Fucking coward, isn't he? Oh, Duracell Bunny! What are you running from? Well, it is true what they say. You are what you eat, said the anteater. Oh, sorry, I should say they're not all funny. Some of them are just beautiful. Oh, there we go. And a two-part of this one about hammerhead sharks. Hammerhead sharks never use their hammer-shaped heads to fix their shipwrecks. Just an observation for you. Part two now. Are they selfish? Fish? Or unable to make eye contact? Just poor at teamwork. Janet never deep-throated her husband. He left her for a giraffe. Oh, gross. Disgusting. Another two-part now about crickets. A cricket doesn't feel his mobile phone go off. His legs are always vibrating. It's silly, that one. Part two now. As a result, his entire family perish in a house fire. So, you know, we can all learn a bit from that. And last but certainly not least, you know, if you want applause until their hands are sore, always leave them wanting... Oh, fuck it. Bye!
Some noise, please! So, I take it you guys go down to the rap night and the poetry night that this night is spawned from, yeah? Who goes down to Hammer and Toe, makes some noise? It's not that busy down there, come on. Who comes down to Slip Jam, makes some noise? You fibbers! You do, yeah, fibbers! You should come down, because we carry on doing this. Well, not all this, some of this sort of stuff. The next guy I met at Slip Jam, actually, about 15 years ago? Fucking serious, that's how long the night's been going. So it's my great pleasure to announce Tej. Make some noise, please!
Hello, everyone. How you doing? That's good. You may notice I'm dressed a bit more stereotypically, maybe how you would imagine a poet might dress. Maybe. It's just a bit of a psychological tactic to unnerve the poets. So we'll see if it works. Hear the beat of the drum. At daybreak, the dreaming is done. Clouds dissipate, reveal the streaming beams of the sun. Nurturing seeds to feed every fetus with love. Germination turned fresh by the breeze from above. Nectar in an intravenous, blessings from the lips of Venus, sending love's subtle secrets as she distribute her teachings. Another fine day to prove we are supple to the seasons. Whisper in the wind, we are dust upon the breezes. Lilies in the field stay arranged with blazing glory, and all of Solomon's splendor can never cater for thee. Slender stalks of nature, all made so gorgeously, painting earth-tone textures to paint an autumn leaf. Or witness these cells in synergy, elegant complicity, reviving the vibrance of legends and history, imbibing the chimes of a delectable symphony, its indescribable delight to elevate the inner stream. Standing where the rivers meet, springing fresh, deliver me. We are channels, we are tributaries, sweet blossom hanging on the mystic tree, or thick webs untangled, slickly meet simplicity. All gather in the lush green orchard, to touch the deep roots, come, lean forward. Find the primordial, receiving the source, it's like nothing previously thought of could ever have brought this. Culmination of every past age and eon, or we have travelled far to create this Eden and seek a crystal lake to lay our aching feet in. Because in this great hall, many kings and queens be seated. Global family gathering united in praise to the glory of Sri Shankar, reciting your names, reside in the spirit, come strike up the flames, sparks dance in the chamber, a lively refrain. A combustion of joy is triggered today, a panoramic painted on an infinite frame. We're speaking love's language so simple and plain upon this ancient island of drizzle and rain.
Glad someone knows the words.
So coming from the cold, let the kinship warm thee. Find a place of calm as the raging storms beat. Witness the daybreak, a new dawn is released. A freshly baked age of adoration and peace. We build temples to worship every being on earth. Liberated from strain, see what dreams will emerge. The fresh mountain spring that you need for your thirst. Filled with wonder like babies been recently birthed. Cause we're the children of the most graceful, tender, supreme. United vibrations in those assembled to see. In this land where the infinite flame does reside, the universal heart prayers embark to the Most High.
Teach! Undoing all the good work that Michael Clark did to smash the stereotypes, that this night was about smashing stereotypes with that fantastically poetical ensemble. It's a real tussle for power up here. So a bit ago, Tom asked you who went to Slip Jam and who goes to Hammer and Tongue, and there was a sort of vague response in both. And it's quite interesting because the rapper's very keen to point out that the audience is a very poetry audience. But no offense, guys, but looking around, you don't look that sophist to me. Not really. But who would say? And there will be three options. The third is I don't know. So don't feel that you have to go for one camp or the other and feel pressured.
I've got a mic here, Rosie, by the way. Yeah, it's ready.
Okay. Well, it's a genuine question. I genuinely want to know. Who here reckons that they would count themselves as a poetry fan? Maybe you're right. Who would say that they are a fan of hip hop?
Yeah. Good hip hop.
Well, if they like you, I guess not. So who here is not sure? They just come along for the crack because it's good fun.
Crackheads.
Yeah, no, didn't like to say. So that means that the major source of result there is either that they're rap fans or they're just here for fun.
Well, I thought about this a little bit, Rosie, actually, and I actually realised my ways. We used to play the pantomime villain, but last year he was such a fucking bitch that I'm cowering down, and I know that you own the stage. You're the villain. I'm sorry.
Okay. All right. Well. Good. So I'm glad that you can accept that fact. But the fact of the matter still remains, despite your attempt to divert it, that it's not that it's a poetry audience and none of them like
it. No, but it's a poetry format. Rosie, it's a poetry format! Get the beats out and let's see you rap on a beat! One year, maybe, that will happen, but we'll just keep doing these acapellas, which all rappers hate. Let's go!
Well, I don't know. Marissa used some music this time. Professor Armamental used some music last time. I'd say that you're doing quite well at doing whatever you want. But nevertheless, we are not in the battle yet. Let's crack the fuck on. And welcome our next poet to the stage, who in fact crosses over both of these genres. Can you please give it up for Cat's Head?
Some more noise, please! Yay!
How you doing? Yeah! Okay, this is a poem I wrote called Will I Ever Leave This Toilet? Sitting in a dingy pub toilet in Brighton, staring at the dismal arrangement of letters that bear the word cock, you will find me, mid-piss, realising 5 minutes before I'm due to play a set that I don't like myself all that much. Plot teaser, I do in the end. I search for my eyes in the mirror. Masked beneath mascara and a mosaic of graffiti genitalia, they look back. Why are we so obsessed with drawing dicks? Why? Exactly. Why can't I get off this lid? I am young, I remind myself. Young and strong, and I can do this. And I am vacant. Mind occupied, heart shaken. Try to breathe and find an inhalant, but there's nothing but me in an air freshener fragrance. I'm lost in a lavatory's layman. My sadness is sticky and my tears are blatant. Excuse me. Yeah? Are you all right in there? Yeah, yeah, I'm fine. I'm really fine. I'm okay. I'm going to be all right in a minute. I'm not fine. Oh, okay. It's just the other toilet's broken and there's quite a long queue waiting. Yeah, I'm just warming up. I was crying. I've become accustomed to toilets. Not in like a weird Mr. Higgins, Eliza Doolittle sort of way, but in their safety. The place where we all meet to piss and gossip, united in our universal need to go. When I was tiny, I used to secretly think, after taking a test at the doctor's, that sometimes my urine looked like bottled sunshine. I really did. I thought I was a fairy. All sunshine wee. And when my doctor told me that my left kidney was removed because it had hydrophenosis and that if I didn't use the toilet regularly enough, the other would malfunction, I laughed. It's funny. I used to have this note, and it read this. Dear sir or madam, if my daughter Catherine asks to use the services during one of your lessons, please do excuse her as she has only one kidney. But I always preferred my own version, which was a rap that went like this. Yo, teacher, let me out of PE, otherwise I'll PE on you. Thank you. If primary school was Monopoly, then that note was my get out of jail card. Cat, are you in there? Cat? Yeah? Do you want a sound check? See, everyone's got their thing. Some people breathe into bags, and I have been known once in a while to cry into toilet towel dispensers. I cried so much once that I actually blocked the bathroom drains. I actually did. Note to self, invest in a decent plumber before my heart gets broken again. I know the comet's carved in every school cubicle I sat in off by heart. The meaning of life is question mark, one asked me. Sarah's shit stinks, the other answered. And my favourite one is this. I was here, because that's all we ever really want, for people to know we were here. To know that your heart beat just as much as the last. We carve our sweethearts into tree trunks and we tell the world, the walls, our secrets. Because it feels safer that way. From cave to cubicle, we have chiseled our catharsis where our arse hits. Light-hearted lines. That one sometimes gets a laugh and sometimes doesn't. I never really know where to go. light-hearted lines made from our darkest. Sometimes the simplest thing feels the hardest. And I wonder why I seem to find myself here so often. Counting the drips from the tap and questioning the skin on my bones. I'm not in primary school anymore and I can't keep using this note. In the end, I do leave the toilet, as you've probably discovered because I'm here right now. It's all terribly poetic and a bit shit, but it's me. And I'm learning to be okay with it.
Some more noise, please. So I don't know if you guys are aware or not, but there's a junior version of this, there's a mini version. The Youth Poets MCs we do, and we need to get more people involved, yeah? So if you guys know anyone who's up for it, I mean, like we do rap workshops for Audio Active as well, shouts out to them. But there's poetry stuff and we do stuff together. And this is a part of the battle, but check this shit out. Last year, we went to every single school between different parts of the team and did an assembly trying to gather people. Every single school. Every child in mainstream education. Yeah, none of them want to do poetry. Just saying that shit, just like, zero. So like the survey went, do you like poetry? And everyone went, no, fuck that shit. So I'm just throwing it in there. Anyway, one of the kids from the rap team is here now. He smashed it 2 years ago, unannounced, took over another guy's place, freestyle, killed it. He's at his spot. Make some noise for Harry, please.
Hello, my name's Fats.
Big Harry Balls!
Fuck off, Heinz. Not happening this year. 2 years now, you fucking embarrass me. Not happening. Also, I want to give a big shout out to Heinz because it's his birthday. Not a day over 21, Heinz. Not a day over 21.
That guy!
And this is the beatboxer, Carrell of our. He's also our part of the rappers, just putting it up now. Just, yeah, we have a beatboxer. Yo, I can paint a picture with the possibilities. Make the world a better place and show with positivity. Like maths, I'm using probability. As the world is being sold as if it is a property. Seriously, we need to try to change the scene. And we will even eat my feet. Doesn't take a genius to see things and not how they used to be. Now I do advise that you try and take a seat. I ain't here to twist your neck and make you bleed. Now I'm believing in that freedom of the speech. How word the rise of the geeks, the fool of the freaks. They told us we'll speak the lord of the beast. And talking with greed and dads always got the master feed. He's always got the master feed. He's always got the master feed. Yo, yo. And honestly, I feel the world's on top of me. And no pressure, but the world's on top of me. I'm counting my blessings, but I'm functioning properly. And no pressure, but the world's on top of me. And honestly, I feel the world's on top of me. And no pressure, but the world's on top of me. Counting my blessings, but I'm functioning properly. No pressure, but the world seems to be on top of me. Yo, it seems to me that lately I've just had a dumb strange. I only got into rap like a few months in danger. Yo, I was kinda lazy. I kinda took my step back cause I kinda went from a little bait. No, I went from a little time and a bit hasty. Little bit tasty, but a little bit masty. Yo, where I went through the park where I used to grab my rhymes and copy and paste it. Yo, it was kinda hard for me, I was going through depression. It was not a nice time for me, so I had a lesson. It was kinda nice lesson though, cause it taught me to be myself in a crowd when I'm low. When you hardly know where you who you really are, it's kind of hard to sacrifice who you really are. So now I stand here in front of you guys and I just really need a drink from the fucking bar. And honestly, I feel the world's on top of me. And no pressure, but the world's on top of me. I'm counting my blessings, but I'm functioning properly. And no pressure, but the world's on top of me. And honestly, I feel the world's on top of me. Counting my blessings, but I'm functioning properly. And no pressure, but the world's on top of me. No pressure, but the world's on top of me. I guess that was a really good opportunity to say that. I was a bit unprepared, like I said, and the second verse was actually freestyle.
Harry! The master of poets, MCs, and the awesome Carell, proving that they might not have it on record, but they most certainly do have beats if they choose. Fantastic. And now we have a man whose very voice is the booming of many instruments. He is the co-host of Hammer and Tongue. Can you please welcome Michael James Parker?
Hello, hello, hello. Yes, I am the host of Hammer and Tongue, which a newspaper once said reinvented poetry for the hip-hop generation, which is nice of them. But I am not from the hip-hop generation. I am from the last generation of rock. And they're taking away the previous generation. They're all disappearing, so let's have a big cheer out for Lemmy! Oh yeah! And his bad drummer, Phil Filthy Animal Taylor! And Rico Rodriguez and Brad Bradbury of the Specials! And the great genius
Boat's Head taught me to dance with my head, and the Specials taught me to dance with my knees, and David Bowie taught me to dance with various magical bits of me, but this poem is about Primal Scream, who taught me to dance with my hands and was the first band to bring me here to Brighton. This is Primal Scream. I want to write poems that sound like a look when I'm dancing. No manifesto, no tale to tell, no pertinent observations on the unfolding nature of universal love except this. I want to write poems that sound like a look when I'm dancing. I want to write poems that move like a move when I'm moving to moving on up. That get up, get on up, and get down, get down. I want to take you to funky town and spin you around in the spinning around of my body, my blood, and my brain. I want to write poems that sound like I feel when I'm dancing. I want to write poems that bring to the surface the smirk of the teenage nerd who still lives about there in my soul and worries she's missing the party and hurts to the point where she catches the stumbling drum riff of In Between Days, and squeezing her eyes tightly closed, she throws back her sweet sorrow head and discovers the cure. I want to write poems miraculous, like that immaculate time during Suffragette City when Mary, the Mother of God, picked me up by the scruff of the neck and Mother of Grace manhandled me onto the dance floor and messed with the strict ordination of time as she dropped my loose body, sweet flesh, to the floor into splits. I've not managed before that or since. And then pulled my puppet strings so it looked like my man strength, propelling me back to my feet and then up to the stars. Ah, wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. Yeah, for David Bowie. I want to write poems that gaze deep dark into the underground club of my soul with its black painted walls and frayed scarlet seating and beer brown dance floor where feet firmly planted to save all from slippage. The dancing begins at the knees. I wobble, I judder, I writhe in adolescent juices to loop and ride and Spacemen 3. And it just when it seems like gravity will override my rigidity, the wall of guitar closes in. You know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about a full-on motherfucking revolution. I want to write poems that move like I move when I'm moving to moving on up. Stepping out of the darkness, enthralled to the blue beating heart of the holy, holy, holy Clapboard Bar, chapel, campfire, circle of song, across the Atlantic and back into my soul, cause I feel it deep down in my soul, and into the soles of my feet, the step up to the altar, as the preacher tells my tale, and the heavenly host know he's telling the truth, and I feel an ecstatic upswelling of joy, right up my prime meridian, and my arms open palms, both by choice and compulsion, open up to the Lord and the lady of my dreams, and my body is the fucking instrument of God, and I'm ready to do the Lord's work. Can you feel the Spirit of the Lord? Can you hear the Spirit of the Lord? Well, thank rhythm and blues, thank peace and love, thank sex and drugs and rock and roll for that. Cheers!
Mike Parker, make some noise, please! That was really good, I really like that. Apart from the bit we said he was going to dance. Pilots can't dance, can they? So next, well actually this is a good link. Because we got someone now that's going to rely just on rhythm. These poets rely just on words, yeah? Yeah?
Yeah?
Yeah? Yeah? Well, we got someone now, and you might not understand her words, but she'll fucking rock this shit. Colette, make some noise, please!
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here. I'm Colette from Spain, and he's Karel from Czech Republic. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoy it with us. Yeah. Yeah. Gone, got you. Right on. Say, yo. Perdóname, fue la venganza dulce de mi subconsciente. Si no estuvo conforme demasiadas veces. Te decís, parece que puedes sobrevivir. Y lo que reprimes al final se vuelve contra ti. Sigo vomitando, referidas sin pañuelo. Esperando en el balcón de tu silencio para no pasar el duelo. Se han cristalizado aquellos versos que me hicieron ser mujer. Asume que el mayor poder es el que crea Génesis, joder. Sin tener que dar cuenta de que hiciste ayer. Dándonos placer, repitiendo hasta el amanecer. ¿Y qué vamos a hacer? Estamos en peligro de extinción, toda una especie. Personajes en la noche, céntricos con clase. Dame los motivos y guárdate la pose. Demasiado roce, no hace tanto, dame tiempo. Si soy un personaje y tú, demasiado cuento. El pretexto, el me pillas en un mal momento. Si te digo, no recuerdo el desenlace de ese día. Miento, otro reencuentro. Amores pasajeros en invierno, convirtiendo el frío del calor que da tu cuerpo. Yo.
Make some noise.
Yo. Ellos buscan palco con tanto calco. Te pierdes jugando en tu propio campo. Tanto que fuimos, quedamos cuando seguimos fumando en el mismo cuarto. Sanse hardcore quemando asfalto, pillando el vicio y el ritmo rápido. Sobra la voz, se me parte el palo. Mira chato, perdiste el tiempo y el encanto. Por lo que nos unió o nos hizo nostálgicos. La atención de aquellos años son la gana con ser mejor. Noche que termina con la gafa de sol y no te voy a disimular. Tengo miedo al pensar que será sin ni mal. Quedadas con vuelta de página. Solo hizo falta palabras para dártelas. No te voy a disimular. Tengo miedo al pensar que será así, no hay más. Quedadas con vuelta de página. De solo hizo falta palabras para hacerte la magia. Para hacerte la magia. Para hacerte la yo. Yeah. Thank you very much for this opportunity. Thank you.
Brighton rappers need to take note. Okay, we have got our final poet of this first half. Can you please give a massive welcome to the stage, changing the mood a tiny touch, to Robin Lawley!
We love you, Robin!
Oh. Robin! Hello. Right. How do I follow someone going fucking mental in Spanish? Well, I had an idea before I got here. It's feeling like less and less of a good idea. But, that almost made me feel as though I'd done me stretching, bending down then. The closest I've come to a good idea to follow that, not knowing in advance that I was going to be following that, was a song. Do you like songs? I mean, we've had Heinze moaning that this doesn't feel like an MC setup. Because, of course, every poetry night has someone beatboxing in the background, or the poetry equivalent playing twee guitar, or just fucking drumming. Whatever. Yeah, this is nothing like any MC night when the middle third of it is devoted to a cipher. Yeah, that's every poetry night I've ever been to. Anyway. Right, who fancy singing some Arabic with me? Okay, bit of a mixed reception to that one. Some people are really proud of being monolingual. Don't ask me to talk any other language, you bastard! I'm paraphrasing, if that wasn't what you meant, I apologise. And some people strangely enthusiastic. I don't quite understand why. Have we got any Arabic speakers in? Yeah. You probably know the tune. Do you want to help me out with it? Because I don't... Yeah, okay, they're shy now. Really doesn't help me bringing attention to them like that. Apparently that it affects some people that way. Okay, I've already got you to... I did say before I got up here I would be essentially finding out how much tumbleweed there is in the room.
Yalla!
Yalla, yalla! Leave
it. Shukran. Okay. Talal al-Badru al-Layna Min thaniyati al-Wada Wa Jabal shukru al-Layna. But do you know the song? مدى لله داء أيها المبوث فينا جيت بالعمر مطاء جيت شرفت المدينة مرحبا خير داء. Okay, there's your bit of Arabic singing just to piss off some of you for reasons. Okay, and the reason that it sprung to my mind is because this song was sung by a group of Canadian school children to some Syrian refugees. It was sung to Mohammed after he returned from exile. It means, to give the abridged version because I didn't write down the full translation, welcome. I also tried to draw an emoji of a party popper, but that doesn't work as well on the page. At first, the response was positive. People were brought to tears by a lovely gesture. Makes me proud to be Canadian. A beautiful tune. You get the gist, but for some this was too much. They've come to invade! Adopting the cunning tactic of starting a civil war to make it all look genuine. This was the considered opinion of one poster, at least the first four words. The rest is just a logical corollary of what they obviously hadn't entirely thought through. Canada is paradise if you come from Bongo Bongo Land, which is just fucking mental. Because I thought Bongo Bongo Land was in Africa and had changed its name after independence. But credit where it's due, at least there was no attempt to hide the racism. They want world domination. This was the most succinct of the contributions from the Tinfoil Hat Brigade. The they in question refers to all Muslims over 1.5 billion, occasionally prone to infighting. I have been reliably informed. Bin Laden was built up as if he was some kind of ultimate villain, his headquarters under a volcano as he threatens to steal the moon. Alas, he was mortal. His replacement, al-Baghdadi, is of course every Bond villain rolled into one with at least three white cats to complete the look. While he plans to take over the world.
Yeah, I could really have been more prepared for this before I turned up. That was kind of it was just essentially saying treat people as individuals and just lazy. We'll get some of the lazy stereotyping later from the MCs when they talk about women in their respectful manner. Just a guess. I might be wrong, but they could surprise me. They could also come out and point out how humble they actually are. But for that, we'll have to see. You've been confusing.
Some more noise, please. I say this because Robin is one of the few guys from that first fateful day when a heckle, don't know what kind of dick would do that, went to the poet's side and this night was born. So make some noise for Robin, please. Okay, this guy's quite new to me, but I'm really interested in what's going to go on tonight. So all pay attention, focus your eyes. This is MC G-Tay, make some noise, please.
Yes, Brighton people, how are we all doing? Man, this looks fucking sick for my beer, mate. You don't realise. My name is MC G-Tech, and over the last 12 months or so, I've been to a lot of the poetry and spoken word nights that these people have been putting on. And they are good, but there's one thing I've made an observation about. And it seems to me that some of the poets don't do the basics of poetry. Now, let me explain what I mean. See, some poets can't rhyme. That's the bit with which they're ill at ease. That lack of rhymes to me displays their limited abilities. They think they're Kenneth Branagh then.
Delivering soliloquies!
Yeah. At least I deliver clever lyrics with agility. Yeah. They couldn't do what I do if we give it till infinity. I know that I'm biased here, but still it is obligatory. For poetry and rhyme, you see, the skill is in the military precision with which words are worked that give them this validity. Else they're just short stories that you've littered with a litany of synonyms and similes you're scribbling so busily. Just because you take words and try and fit them in so prettily, yeah, they think that they're all raconteurs or wittering so wittily. But poets who can't rhyme are like a vitamin deficiency. It's like not eating pasta if you live in Little Italy. I was wrong, I thought that I could live with it initially, but what they do is boring, I'm admitting it officially. It seems like their approach is in the grip of inefficiency. They can't recall their work because they've written insufficiently. I take the time to learn my rhymes and spit them with proficiency. And I can keep them going with a rhythmic consistency. Got the skills to carry on and kick them this persistently. They have to get their book out, we stop grimacing so visibly. And they ain't exactly got a rivet in delivery, so spare us all the hell of that derivative proclivity. They seem to think that rhyming is the tip of imbecility. Stop sticking to them guns with such a rigid immobility. Cause if this is fuckwittery, just quipping shits are flippantly, then how come they can't do what I exhibit with profligacy? To call what they do poems takes the piss and it's a liberty. So pop your rhyming cherry, lose your limerick virginity. This style is slowly dying out, both figurative and literally. And with this little rhyme right here, I've written its obituary. And I know I'm gonna get some shit for this, predictably. But I would rather have a mix of syphilis and dysentery than listen to another poem written with the misandry that says they don't like life because they're stricken with the misery that all them tortured souls need so the slipper fits exquisitely. When tears roll down their cheek, they think, how bitter this salinity. I dropped my bloody iPhone to help Britain its fragility. They're metaphors for life and why I live on its periphery. And rappers cop some flack from them for chilling with a spliff or three. But until you've tried it, quit dismissing its epithely. Cause due to the combining of a little bit of epiphany, the rhymes will come together and what's written is a symphony. They'll probably try it too now that I've triggered this epiphany. Cause when it comes to poetry, this shit is its epitome. So choose your way, accept defeat with bitterness or dignity. I think we know who's won here, I'll consider this a victory. Big up yourselves, Brian! Thank you very much for listening!
This is the interval, right? We normally invite loads of rappers on stage, and you are all welcome on stage if you can get past the bouncer. You are all welcome. But this time, I brought a gang of young people from Audio Active. Make some noise, please! Our youngest rappers are 14 years old, so imagine yourself at that age getting on this stage, please. It's a big opportunity. I want you to show them some support. But that isn't even this. They're going to fucking smash it. Let's have some beats, please, Tiny. This is Slim Jim. Yo.
You first.
What?
Yo. Yo.
Okay, yo, yo, this is Slim Jam and Audio Active. Yo, ignore the theatrics, talking to practice. We get on this shit, we bring it in borderline, don't we know all just spastics.
Yo, I said you first, now it's time to freestyle and spit a fucking new verse. As I spit it quick, fam, yeah, I represent Slim Jam. I put my name on the card, I'm raising the bar.
Raising the bar, I'm blazing behalf. Yeah, if you go on a step to these kids, they might be half your age, but they bars, they make up in a lava state. Bubbling over like just Vesuvius, mate. It's toothpaste, none of this is too fake. Where's coming in with the boom back bass? Are you ready, mate? Yeah, 3, 2, 1. Yes, falling off some bars off your head top, son.
Poetry, a joke, man. Take one pop of smoke in your bar with your mates. Nah, pussy, go home. Your rhymes just ain't got chemistry. You think you're sick? Well, then. I set the place on fire like gasoline. Lips look chapped, can bring you all your Vaseline. It's a catastrophe when I rap for free. This ain't rugby, so why are you trying to tackle me?
Yo, yo, yo. elaborate on my lyrical plan. Bars on my iPhone, you can say that in my hands. Stay calm fam, it's never about making grands. It's just about spitting man, even say wagwan to your gran. Across the nation, I say what I want, no reconciliation, stay patient. Nowadays, most can't afford the basics, but yo, some pee would be nice to splash at night. It's never gonna happen unless I follow the hype and spit lies. But nah, that's not right. I wanna finish a set and leave the mic alight. While high as a kite with raw truth and a few tales from my youth. Yo, erupt on the sea like Pompeii in the booth. I'll handle these whack MCs and new. Yo.
Yo, this little kid has an appetite. I met him freestyle in the corridor at Patcham High. He bust a few bars for me. He had a whole armory, hit me so alarmingly. Flowing like margarine, where's when you bust another little bit? Make a sound just with the little kids and make the gibberish tumble like your mouth, like you're intricate, like a licorice or a bit of pick a mix.
I like to freestyle, it's my main function. Rap is the sick shit. I'm hungry, like it's lunchtime. In school, 12:20, that's my one time. Hit it for me one time, two time, three time. Everybody knows I'm so sick when I rhyme on a freestyle. Top of the game, I'm only 14, but this rap game still gets slayed by me.
Take you right back before I existed. Then I sprung into life and decided that I didn't want to miss it. Why? Cause every day it's all the same, just banging out in my brain. Yo, I can't seem to decide in which way is wrong or which way is right. And every day it seems the same as I travel each way. It's all the same, yo. Yo. Many a lad, many a time, fed his lies. Turned the court, moved fast, managed to victimize. Told his lies, yeah. Number 10, thinking of his immortality. Ha! The joke of our nations, bombing with no hesitation. Kids with no money for operations, tearing up our occupations, cause it's all going bad like fermentation. Yeah, certain victims' memoration, I suggest we leave the federation like a murmuration. Cause now we complain about immigration, even though putting first the world largely slave movement for slave trade. But now we're afraid, cause the state we make me wanna blow like a renegade. Yeah, cause a white man with a gun, they call it an anomaly. Immigrants coming in, they call them a threat to society. One attack and it's a global catastrophe. Cause of you, how many died with no recognition cause of their race or religion? Listen, yeah. For example, how many ethnic minorities died in police custody? Crusader, Michael Brown, just 18. Yeah, Trevor Martin, Huey, Dondre Hamilton, shot by Chris Panny.
James! It's on you. Right.
Poetry, you think rappers are beneath them? You see, that's your weakness. You sprite out the ground like unkillable creatures. A life is riddled with seniors, telling us our culture is meaningless. Meaningless? What you mean? With art, I'm raising the bar to the ceiling, cause like, I'm like half your age, and that's being generous. I'm right, you are back, you're so old, you are back then writing Genesis. And we're here right now fighting menaces. I've lost count of the bars, I count them in sentences. But I mean, fuck that, I mean paragraphs. You haven't got enough ammo to beat one of us. You can never be one of us. You've lost this nice and now we're running past. You couldn't keep pace just against one of us.
Yeah, let's go.
Yo, take a listen, yo. Yo. Yo, so I've been filling out my mind, trying to locate the truth, though I know it's hard to find. Going through the different dissect, try and intercept, try and relocate the truth, try and raise my intellect. No, I know it's hard to find, trying to locate the truth. Going through this diamond mind, I'm going through the toughest things that you've ever seen. Trying to chase just reality and chase my dreams. Yo, I'm going through this different stacks on track. I wanna know if you can face the truth, try and just combat. Feeling like a heavyweight, there's no debate, it's great. Going through the different shoulders, I'm older, I'm wiser. Yo, so So I've been facing the truth, going through the different levels, feeling so confused. I'm feeling like I'm going through a different type of way, trying to keep my own brain contained. There's no shame. Woo! See, I've been feeling so benevolent, I've got a higher reach. There's obsolete, fuck it, I've been going through a different type of niche. Don't even try and just compare when you've got nothing, you're not even able just to wear.
Make some noise. Let's go, hey.
Yo. 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 I can see your eyes looking at me by. Why you looking me by? Why the time living in a lie? My whole life I felt like I'm living in a lie. But not being serious though, cause I'm living time. Yo. So sometimes I live a lie when you're living dressed. When you're never living right, when you're living stressed. Never know your life when you're lying to life. And even though your dad don't love you, man, that's just right. I pick up all the people who never listen to me. I pick up all the people that just judge and respect to me. I pick up all the people that put their trust in me to make the music better and show that I'm an MC. Woo! And a little...
Yo, poets versus MCs, you pricks beyond mental. Tonight I'm here to kill kids, call me John Venables. I know my humor's dark, slash terrible. I bury human parts in the park, yeah, like a vegetable. Shot hash, got gash in the festivals. Got smashed in a safe cash, I spent it all. Sniffing bags, sipping yak till my speech is straight up illegible. My mind's a fourth man, you know it's impregnable. I'm more than capable. These bars I lay down, they might just disable. I can tell a story, I can spit a fable. My shit is never boring, my shit will turn the tables. Yeah, yeah, cause I'm a drunk prick with the liquor up inside him. I mix my white drugs and green one sip dry gin. I don't sip vodka, I ain't trying to get violent. I ain't trying to get by the court, but I ain't trying to get caught by the sirens again, my friend. But it seems that whatever the poison, bro, still acting like boisterous. Kept it with a moisture slot, a moisture bitch, you roll with it. So I got to poke it quick, I bounce home to roll up the dope with shit. I pop beats.
This is it, we got you for our size. Not typically all the usual guys. We can do this, don't get confused with eyes. It's a way we can take this and use our stuff in a different way, dissipate. What I do with this, your mates. Isn't it great? We got the younger kids. Come on with this, they can euthanize. There's youth in the times.
Younger kids. You know. Dropping bars like it's thundering. Ain't this Concord Simkin chip? No, bro, it's 7-Eleven. I'm just falling bars from the top of my cerebellum. Just spitting a melon. Can I tell him? Popping with audio active. Bars spark so hard, it's like chain reactions. Boom, yeah, we're locked in the room. You're just listening to an empty from the voodoo groove. Collect. Do what you gotta do, spit the Spanish on the mic, blowing up like T-dynamite till the eyes blow up like China White. I spit chemicals, call me iodine.
Nena y escenario se sucede la ciudad, más que hablar con las palabras solo han de disimular. Te has parado a pensar si las caras son enmascaradas, si las etnias típicas son típicas de manada. Da igual si siempre acá con las letras mojadas. Si has soñado en la ciudad de piel y ritmo, naufragas. Es el papel del que no quiere ser matador, el mismo que quiso buscar la cuerda del telón. Yo, con la colaboración de la afición en cada acción, personas andan solas sin llevar su dirección. Y fafe de filet con el fin, el círculo se cierra. Hoy se representa una película en la tierra.
With our bars, we express the magic. You see our youngsters, the talent. But the go-ahead is when we rap in different accents. As we come and track sparring, but we watch it cause we got the gadgets. We feel the magic. Watch it, it's apparent as I go ahead and climb on this mountain. I got my ambition, I'm feeling this mission. And it's a tradition, so rap for the villain. Yo.
High tech, getting a weapon check. Because the mecha Godzilla with Manila's gonna reconnect. Baragon stomping on you like a rhino. The Cyberdyne systems, heavy metal dino. Guy can attack an asinine tornado. Leaving it thinking, man, little the fuck did all the grain go. Larry will attack the final fight against the Raiju. Ultramanic, classic, Draculactic kaiju. Titanosaurus, you're gonna be behind you. Hazardous, it's arrogant, and permanently blind you. Honest, on the bars back, I wanna divide you. Here we go, I've got the fucking kaiju pass to this little guy. I'll tell you what, he's better than any of the poets in the sky. Their fucking minds are high, they must be high. Why would they come here and look like that kind of guy?
Cerberus. Yeah, you should be nervous. Spit poison through my verses. Good rap about politics and society and how the government relies on me.
happy, but I'd rather buy a fat zeg and get too high. On the heavy end of it, there's a detectable point, you're a fraction of actual happiness. The having a lover is having when fracturing a lover is having a fight with a catalyst. Never inviting, capturing, and ending, gradually, rapidly panicking. The old glass matching the shattering, there's still some fragments of sanity, having some arrow in. Gathering arrogance, shambling back in the battlements. At first, even in bleeding between the increase of a fraction, cracking lips, I'm slagging a hand a bit, fight back and increase, so life I'm out of it. A permanent capture in the past, and it's very cracked, and manuscripts attacking the shaking hand, but it's bad to the matter, is scratching the back into inadequate. Rapping the mouth, I'm out of syllables, it's okay, I'm still killing fools. I don't take it to literal, pass it on to the next guy, stimulate you like clitoral.
Check it, some real bars. Let me take you right back. Before I existed, then I sprung into life and decided to kiss it. Bless you, such a curse. As I got older, it got worse. With my parents love fake, why don't you call me a nurse? Realising that my troubles was outside my own bubble put me into perspective. That I'm a little piece of stubble on a woman's face. Why? Because she hasn't shaved for days. But ask her, allow her, she's been out of care to rave. Why? Because I'm divorced, who's got her as a horse. Jaking off from a K-hole and asking for second course. Why? Because I'm not think I'm fucking like that. Why? Because I don't even fucking have that, yo.
Mom and my sisters in the crowd. Every time I spit a freestyle, I got spit loud. Got me sick, top of the charts. I can rap fast, man, it ain't a hard task, man. Seriously, I'm the illest, don't come to me with your neck. Seriously, I will twist it, I'm the sickest. Call me menace, one mind that I've got to live with. Smile on your face like it's Christmas. Seriously, no, I am ill still. Don't cut with me, take a chill pill. Think I'm bad? Suck your mom. Rape me? Fun that cost.
If you wanna know what magic means, poetry just makes me wanna go to the lavatory. If you're asking me which one is better, it's not a good competition. Don't know why I'm here again. When I'm here again, let's hear it then. I've got a whole beat up on my head like we're in them. I'm in the pyramid, thinking about this Egyptian shit. Egyptian shit, I'm moving past Egyptianness. Don't know what I'm on about. On about, I'm on a now, I'm on a cloud, up lie, never mount. Like I'm walking past the planes, walking past the names in the high sky like the high rollers. I high roller like a 12-12 holder.
Yo.
Burgundy, I'll spell it to man like ABC. I'll sell it to man like Jack Dorsey. Emotions guard to me on the inside, harder than hard. Screw the world to Mars. Cause mental lines are deeper than anything physical, deeper than passion for anything. Liverpool, I'm so lyrical with each syllable. I spit another miracle, but nothing at all compared to what you could be known for. So disturbed that you could argue death could be ethical and even called for. Man, is this what we warred for? And I know it might not be applauded for, but it's called for. Cause every time I open my mouth, it's sore like an ulcer. So I don't expect no encore, but I'm gonna pass it on now, cause my time's out, pal.
Yes, Bury, but any horror fans in the house, say hey! Bury the derelict, snitch, stumbling fools that can never live. Get caught in a cold ditch with the mist and dead on the soulless old bench and the bitch shunning the homeless old wench, letting pensioners struggle in debt. You rappers discovered the day nest and everything's dead yet. The full moon is never forgetting the cold flesh. All you degenerate ghouls could care less, God bless. Yes, invincible dead's fresh. Broken dolls, swallowed souls in Fred's chest. I'm getting older, waiting for death's best. Elvira's the girl, beautiful bell with big breasts. I'm a Cenobite, ever living the devil gin. Pinhead bitch and I'm pissing into the parfin. Wishmaster spitting over the Trojan. I put salt on Uncle Frank with no skin. An abramelin smelling the burning feathers. And ever winning the Larry, I'm killing the fucking heathers. An evil Don walking along with no brainers. Morgan Long walking around with bro trainers. Pass to the next hit.
Yeah. Yeah, so take a listen, I've been filling out my mind. There's no way that I can see stuck in a tragedy. I know it's hard to breathe, stuck beyond the needed limits. I wanna know if you can see the truth, whether or not you're just in it. Stuck in a microwave, hard to tame, it's hard to chase. Stuck between a benevolent case. I keep ever bruising and choosing, trying to figure out the truth. Stuck between the depths, but I must conclude. Stuck beyond the furthest depths. I've been hard, but I'm trying to raise my intellect. Different prospects, I know it's hard to see, but kinda stuck. But harder ends of a tragedy. I'm wide awake, I'm ready just to go with me fate. Knowing I'm so compassionate. There ain't no worries, there ain't no blues. I'm just a normal guy like you who's just learned to feel the groove. I'm constantly glued 9 to 5 to the music. Living in this way in my brain, man, I couldn't quite choose it. And what a shame.
Make bigger some noise! Make some noise for everyone, please. I think it's really important. Yeah, you guys killed it. So seriously, make some fucking noise. Right, basically, I was rapping at their age. At 14, I was definitely rapping. But if you'd have put me in front of a crowd like this, I can't even perceive what I would be now. Make some noise for those young guys, please.
Oh yeah, who was here last year? Oh, so previously, none of the rappers used to ever say anything about me. Obviously they knew that I was so cool. But two of them have specifically come up to me and said, I just want you to know that we are friends and I'm really sorry, but
wow.
Trigger warning me. Yeah, trigger warning the bejesus out of me, which is quite kind because I never do the same for them.
Well, to be honest, Rosie, I did slag you off quite hard and get booed by about 700 people one year. So we do say things about you.
Yeah. I guess I'd just forgotten that because it wasn't very well done. But anyway.
It was me.
I know, and not like
yeah,
now.
I didn't amble enough, did I? I didn't ramble around the houses, I just kind of said it.
Yeah, it was too direct,
it was
there was
concise.
No
concise, yeah.
Anyway, guys, get on the fucking stage, where are you? Where are all the poets?
We need all the rappers and all the poets. The young guys can get involved too. Anyone involved can get up on stage. Let's form some sort of division that the crowds will appreciate, because they want to see an underdog, don't you?
They're not going to move.
Well, let's go. Now, first of all, we're going to go tonight. I don't know what his real name is. He's going to take this shit a pieces. Make some noise, whatever his name is. Make some noise. I seriously don't know what's going on right now.
Is Gramsci. And I am standing in the most electrifying, super styling, party all night and gay, riding naked, bike riding, miracle, spiritual, lyrical city in all of Great Britain. If you're happy to live in Brighton City, give me a hell yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls and children of all ages, I would like to welcome you to the greatest city on earth. And the greatest city on earth deserves the greatest show on earth. This is Poets vs. MC Mania! Now, man, I've got a little question that I have to ask, man. Yeah, man, I'm a curious cat, man, you know what I'm saying, man? Yeah. I see a whole lot of faces. I see a whole lot of motivated people that tells me one thing, that all of you left your houses, you're strapped on your boots, you faced the awful Great Britain weather, and you came here for one reason. So I want to hear the answers to this question.
Did you come here to watch Team MC face Team Poetry and Team Poetry face Team MC and to watch these guys rip each other limb from limb? Did you want to see them rip each other's get guts out? And number one most important question, if you came here to see Blur, give me a hell yeah! Well, oh no, no, no. And man, let me tell you a little something, brother and sisters. Tonight, you ain't gonna see no blood. I know, man, but this is how it goes. We've been part of this team for a long time, man, yeah. Team MC has been like a wild dog, man, yeah. And we have been growling, and we've been snorting, and we've been barking, but you gotta understand. That's the thing about dogs. If there's a dog who is so determined, he will chase you to the end of the world just to bite your head off. At the end of the day, you start to respect that son of a bitch. Yeah! That's what happened here last year, man, yeah. I saw respect in these people's eyes. And that is why Big Daddy Hines, my manager, dropped this microphone to the floor and it ended in a draw. I got some good news to tell you people, man, yeah. This is the greatest city on earth and we are a city of community. Why on earth do we need Brighton Poets versus Brighton MCs when the better option is to have Brighton Poets combined with Brighton MCs? We have got right here the contract, which was written up by us MCs, and it says PVMS, which looks like it stands for Poets versus MS. That's a whole agreement. No, this is Poets versus MCs for the time that you'll see right there. Once this contract is signed, what teams can combine? That's what I'm talking about. The team of the MCs and the Poets, the two of us together, can take on the entire verbal wrestling world, man, yeah. Are you ready to sign? Yes! I said, are you ready to sign?
I don't know what he got going on about there. Well, I mean, I'm thinking here, what is the poetry equivalent of a man having a fake chair broken over his back? I don't know. What is the poetry equivalent of some kind of weird flashback to about 1990 when I used to watch this shit at school? I don't know. Just emphasizing the lack of preparation.
Rehearsal. Make some noise!
So you people came here to see blood. Well then, that's exactly what you got, because we're back at war, man, yeah. It strikes me just a little bit suspicious that when we're about to sign a contract of unity, that a local poet humiliates me and Robin Lawley drunkenly makes a fucking asshole of himself. Oh, yeah. I am gonna hurt you, man, and I mean I'm gonna really hurt you. I'm not talking about slapping you in the face, and I ain't talking about no knuckle sandwich neither, no. I'm gonna strap you to a chair, and I'm gonna make you listen to Cher's "Do You Believe in Love After Love?" for an entire week, man, yeah. I'm gonna send your daughter to a right-wing university. She's gonna study economics, and she's gonna come back home and say, "Mummy, the Conservative Party actually has some quite good ideas." Yeah. But before then, I'm gonna let you know what you two really are, yeah. Cause Michael Barker sees himself as the big bear. Rosie Garrick sees herself as some sinuous, sexy, venomous snake. but I see them both as two little mice. And you're two little mice looking up at me, and I'm gonna raise my boot. I'm gonna squash you both, pick you up by your tail, spin you around, keep spinning, and throw you back in the garbage where you and your friends found your poetry in the first place. Because people, they do say that honesty is the best thing. And in all honesty, I don't want to be a part of a fucking fake feud as fake as the feuds in professional wrestling. Because this year is gonna get extremely real. So here we go, Brighton, this is the deal. We're gonna see a little bit of freestyle glory. I'm gonna rap a line and you're gonna finish it for me. So here comes the practice round for you. Here we are standing at the Concord. All right, man. Another little practice round is what we're gonna do. Here we are standing at the Concord. I went to the bar like, oh my dear, £4 for one little? That's what I'm talking about, because you know it. This is MCs versus the... But who wins? I guess you choose. But the MCs will win and the poets will. You see me rhyme with our crowd and you just fucking read to yours. We're MCing and we're knowing that we're living in the sea of doors, because I brought a little bit of the metaphors. So here we go once again with this fucking war. But saying that we are the immoral team is a distant dream, and let me show you what I mean. Every time we freestyle or write a rhyme that crosses the line, the poets cry in their moral panic. But the only person to be sexist here in the last few years is you, Rosie Carrick. Because according to Rosie, only a male rapper would be so arrogant to begrudge a teenage boy a part on the poetry team, and only a male rapper. Well, that's interesting, Rosie. Only a male rapper. Because I know that if a male rapper was in this microphone and in a negative tone, saying only a female poet would be so arrogant, yeah? Only a female poet, you would fucking lose your mind, and you know it. So quit your act as the thick-skinned wicked witch, because you are the most sensitive and easily offended person on this entire premises. And we believe that feminism is a synonym for equality, so doesn't that make you a pretty shit feminist? Oi, and you're telling me that you had the temerity to tell Spliff Rick to smoke less dope? How can you tell Spliff Rick to hit less spliffs when you yourself need to sniff less coke? Hair! Purr! Crit! And Michael James Parker should have been a little smarter, because this month he's been a bit of a fool. I'm not ungrateful at all that he invited me of all people to perform at the Royal Albert Hall. But Michael, do you not think it was a little stupid to sit me down in a pub and admit that you needed me, a freestyle MC, because I quote, Gradsky. Group poetry is just kind of shit. They were your words, Susan, not mine. Group poetry is just kind of shit. Well, at least you've got a nice little slogan to come out of this. It's a nice little one. Put it up in gold, make it all nice. Something you can laminate. Hammer and Tongue, Brighton Poets. We cannot collaborate. And why can't you collaborate, Susan? Rosie, Robin, Chris. I've actually done 15 minutes apparently, fucking hell, so I need to finish this. At the end of the day, this is the freestyle, and infuse me for all the fake bleeding, but we're just needing and we keep freeing because we keep coming with these bleasins. Bleasins? There's not even fucking a word, but this is the damn point. We are coming with our lyrical swords. And I will not be fucking satisfied until you have all been sacrificed by Team MC's lyrical fucking beheadings. Which is very hard to take seriously by a guy with a fake like this, wearing pink leggings. Big up Brighton, Team MC, make some fucking noise. This is Poets versus MC Mania.
With so much promise, didn't it? Yeah, if you mean the most sensitive person because I don't take any bullshit from the sexist baloney your team used to take, then yeah, I am fucking sensitive. And you may say that it's exactly the same thing to say, oh, when a male rapper says that, blah, blah, blah. And damn right I would say something about it if you were like a female rapper. Because the difference is, A, rappers are traditionally misogynist, and B, there is no history of thousands of years of oppression from women to men. So if you think that it's me being a bad feminist to specifically call out a guy being a dick, then you do not understand equality, my friend. And group poetry is fucking shit. It's banal, ridiculous stuff that prevents you from saying anything. But I don't know why that's hilarious, because none of us are group poets. It's not like we're being contradictory in any way. Okay, you might have noticed that Gramsci's stuff is likes to think that it's moved on. It's interesting that he calls me out on my feminism, but he says I see myself as a sensuous, sexy snake. Actually, I see myself as a mother, a fantastic PhD student, translator of Russian poetry. It's just that I also happen to be fucking sexy. That's a sideline thing. Mate, I've never seen anyone dig themselves such a big hole. I'm gonna risk turning into him and going over time, so I'm gonna crack the fuck on with it. Brighton rapper and legendary wasteman Big Dave Enlish said on this event's Facebook page, from, I should add, the safe embrace of his Central Hove home, where these days he lives clean and sober, growing fruit in his garden. His last appearance at this show, no hip-hop battle rap piece, but simply a melancholy poem that Poets MCs does not, in fact, as its tagline states, smash the stereotypes of each respective side. Meanwhile, Hinesy Hines, for something like the ninth year running, when asked for a quote on Poets MCs, said, yet again, the rap team plays the pantomime villain so the poets can eat our shit and follow our lead, or similar. Now, aside from the fact that your team neither plays nor gets treated like pantomime villains, and that to suggest such a thing is evading the fact that whenever you've been booed off the stage, it's not because you've been playing a role. It's simply because the audience knows that empty space is more entertaining than most of your unruly troupe of facepalm generators, who between them have historically had all the artistic foresight of Robin Thicke typing up the lyrics to Blurred Lines and thinking, ooh, the women will love this shit. Aside from that, have you genuinely not noticed that at Poets MC's 2016, there are no make-believe villains versus goodies excuses for losing to hide behind? And look over, glance at their loveliness. They're like a team of Care Bears, but more colorfully dressed and in some cases shorter. This event, as it now exists, undoubtedly smashes old stereotypical myths about rappers and poets. However, as those of you who've been here for the long haul will have seen, those rap stereotypes have not been smashing themselves. And for that matter, the fact of their smashing has never been merely a side effect. You see, the changes that have taken place on their side of the stage have been the central aim of these events from the beginning. One night, 13 long years ago, the poets got together and made a plan to satisfy our fine sadistic pleasure. Specifically, we devised this entertaining situation where we'd pick up a load of insecure, thrusting reprobates and systematically bully away their core beliefs in public till they were gagging to try to remake themselves in our image, and lo, Poets MCs exploded into existence. Being rappers, the only way to lure them in initially was baiting their testosterone by making it competitive. So, under that guise, since 2004, we, the poets, have taken pride in diminishing all they stood for. Consider their trajectory. Gone are the days of the early years when in their blissful ignorance they leapt round the stage like a team of hopeful dildos on a true love waits date, legaling out of their primordial suit barely literate digs at our imaginary quill pens, garret slums and my capacity to swallow their jizz. The phrase, as you know, no homo, was bandied around like billio, but increasingly, and unbeknownst even to themselves, it seems, it signified not no homosexual, but now no homo sapien. For like reverse Pinocchios, the way they fling their limbs around the stage is their acknowledgement of status. A brightly painted team of almost lifelike marionettes whose only way to win has been to try to emulate us. Educating themselves on concepts like wit and non-misogynistic swearing, I believe the stuff they've got lined up tonight, they've spent all year preparing. Ed, I think, has proven that already. But what high price for egos like theirs in a battle of the sort this show is, to know the only way to be clever at rap is to try to act like poets. So bear in mind, you brotherhood of brainwashed pound shop discount versions of the Brighton poetry team, you slobbering packs of Pavlov's dogs at the heels of the spoken word scene, that every joyous feeling you will ever glean from every fleeting burst of applause you each receive is merely the proof our victory over your brittle spirits brings. Your only self-made assets, your capacity to be systematically reprogrammed, so aspire to all the heights you like, but we'll still be pulling the strings.
Yo. Here's a man camera, let's make some noise!
Firstly, it's nice to see that the poets still haven't learnt from last year, they haven't learnt to memorise lines and so they're reading bits of paper, which is fucking boring. But yo, I'm gonna pick apart the poets for posing all so pretentious, play the polar position to their many imperfections. Dull wit, dress sense, permanent lack of presence, calling me to conclude they just left an amateur Victorian dramatist convention. Am I correct to assume you'll assume this stance? Talking eloquently about distance. This is an impression of you. Raising yourself up to the lofty heights of the gods, pointing down on us like distance. Lights, camera, impact. I'll just stand here and do this dance. Fuck that. I'm here to cause cracks on the glass, your think tank. Titanium fist bang. Reason your Titanic-sized ship sank, Sinbad. You have valiant grammar, but damn it, your standards are whacker than Thatcher or cancer. Your Han Solo without Chewbacca. Average, but where's the... You need to listen to more Africa Bambaataa. Bring a little bit of rhythm and some shabba. When was the last time, in fact, whenever has someone come up to you like, yo, Carol Ann Duffy just dropped a banger? Never. Your culture's culinary cuisine is a caveat of caviar served on a silver platter using status and eloquent language to imply that you're better. That's backwards. My prose rolls in rolls to erode your inflative ego, torpedoes to the dome just to show that we have the superior genetic codes. Yeah, we have musicality and entertainment. That's the rap chromosome. I'll poke holes in the poet laureate so I can sift through your shit, use her as a colander, because you can't store flows plus it's draining and straining when you bother to drop a verse, you proper nerd. And I'd say you lot are washed up, but that actually implies you do any work. See, you probably had half your verses ghostwritten by your butler slash nanny slash concierge. You white privileged pseudo-intellectual ink spillers. See, poets prehistoric relics for not recognizing rapping is the shiznick. This is survival of the fittest. Bringing an essence of finesse when we be etching with our pens with the letters that we project to condemn them with disrespect. If you step in and think against, warning venomous from the head of this clever kid, call him Campbell, the scribbling never ends. Yes. Cause rap's definitely best. And we're definitely winning. I'm done, I'm telling you, we're all finished. Time.
What can I say? Wasn't that excitable? I quite agree, we are not whack. Is that the right? I'm not really down with the youth. It's not really, you know, I mean, admittedly, half of their team reminded me of going to my nephew's birthday party and feeling as though I couldn't emphasize enough that I'm an uncle. That I had a right to be there. Oh. So I'm detecting a little bit of anger on their part. I don't know if that's just me. I did, admittedly, today pick up a book about psychology. You know, maybe that's just too much reading for them. Evidently, reading is to be frowned upon. Yet I have to be able to remember shit from the top of... or something, I can't remember. It's not my fault that I've had a couple of breakdowns and a few too many concussions to be able to put these things securely in my head. So let me just try and run through what's just been said. I have been honoured to be involved in this farce of an event since the very first 13 years ago, which leaves me very honoured. I don't know why that got whooped, but thank you. Which leads me to ask the one question that strangely went straight over the heads of some of the younger members of their team. Are you not entertained? Yeah! That's after all why we're here. Not the fact that even after a draw, someone decided to make their own belt. I find that a little bit confusing. And admittedly, for many of those 13 years, it wasn't the poets that swayed the audience. It was more the MCs with being ever so smooth and their subtle variations on how they would say, Rosie, I would. I mean, they'd rhyme with it, but it was essentially as sophisticated as that. Or how, oh, what was it, last year we asked some people to come down from London and one of them offered to fuck someone straight. Yeah, that was never going to be a crowd pleaser, that line. Yes, that did come from London. Oh, the chap who said it was actually from South Africa. Like I give a shit. It's essentially the same... yeah, this is why I shouldn't get too drunk before doing this. Utter lightweight these days, and you'll find that happens as you get older. It's the same ethic. How many raps do you hear about people being humble? Just... Or saying that, we all just want peace, man. Put your gat away, or... whichever is the more up-to-date reference to a firearm. Or when they're referring to other people who get picked on like Muslims and just saying, yeah, we're all good. Fuck it, anyone gets in between me and my curry, I'm going to hit them. Or, you know, they'll say it in an aggressive manner, of course. Or being aggressively pro-equal rights because, yeah, that really didn't wash, claiming that Rosie was the only sexist person that approached the microphone. Not that you'd ever come up and just try to use this thing as some kind of substitute in the same way that firearms fans do. Come up here and speak so fast that you'll all be astonished and at the same time imagine what it's doing. It's not particularly sophisticated, I know. I'm partly just getting this out of the way because I need another beer. Because someone ordered me an ale, I don't know what this selection like is like in this venue. I'm going to get out of the way because it's just been emotional. What can I say? I hope you enjoy the rest of the evening.
Make some noise for Robin, please. He's one of the originals. He still hasn't got any enthusiasm about it, though, has he? But anyway, I think it's time for a guy. He's known as Feldman nowadays. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise!
Nobody puts Judacris in the corner. I'll bring in the 2-2. Turn the stage to an arc. You'll get removed and laid to the past like student maintenance grants. I could be cruising, facing some sharks in waves that are harsh, and I'd still keep it ever steady when maintaining my craft. because you're making a mark. Barely got to say, oh, hi, before I was made to a mark. I hit the stage with a swathe of remarks. I was waste, but reclaimed it as fast. I couldn't spray, but I framed it and laughed. But it's pretty hard to save face when your face is a mask. Yeah, it was great for a lark. But when I really started shaping my bars and creating some art, I became my own BB-8. Plotting my way to the stars to find a lonely lost soul who's escaping his past. Each time making them laugh because I'm afraid that they'll laugh. With everything I say, I'm thinking that I straighten my path. I'd leave a cipher and I'd think, is this the way that you are? So Reverend, if you still got that invitation at large, I'd like to cross over to your side of the stage before making a start. Thanks, real dad. This is a poem I did called I Did a Poem. I am Zephaniah, if he accepted his OBE title with a smile. I am Spike Milligan if he went the Chuckle Brothers kind of way. I am a pug in a violent fervor gnawing on Byron's face. I am Sylvia Plath trying to end it all on the defrost option of a microwave. I am emotional. Pauses, hearts on sleeves, frogs in throats, wit. I am sibilance lingers, clicking off fingers when the concepts don't click. I am the chiseling of an ex's name into the molten bark of a fragmented sodium bicarbonate sausage copter. I am open square bracket controversial sex reference. Close square bracket. I am Chekhov's water pistol. I am Chekhov, another item on the list of pretentious things I want to mention. I am changing the world, one audience that already completely agrees with everything I say at a time. I am the proud father of an ecological poem so important that the vast expanses of the Amazon rainforest were cleared, producing the 15 fucking reams of paper I am reading it off of. I am the piece so memorable I still need to be read from a teleprompter 13 years later. I am the resonant fart in the ideological echo chamber. I am looking for a way to bring people together, ways super close together, in the name of bringing people together, together, we can make the world a better place. I am the most important thing in this room! I am no ideas. I am the rhymes that sputtered to a dying halt before they reached this passage of text. I am the bell of the ball in my death of formal structure matching pajama set. I am slyly slipping the death of formal structure matching pajama set back into its neatly alphabetized storage container. I am the mantras I speak in. I am the absence of meaning. I am throwing grains of quinoa at KFC from a Pizza Hut delivery bike. I am bored. I am going back to the rap team now. I don't need a cue card to spew hard. I might have learned my lines. You lot missed the point more than me after I was circumcised. Yeah, I don't think that you're the worthy side. I ain't lying. I'll move fuss at you off a cliff. It doesn't hurt my pride. So I stream light speed back to my side of the equator. This is how you make words concrete without needing paper. Excuse your behavior, cause poets versus MC stage is a teenager. It's your bar mitzvah. So grow up, mazel tov, fuck off, and see you later.
I feel like to entirely channel Moz Prob's imitation of a poet, I need to hold the piece of paper in front of my face whilst I read from it. Of course I read off a bit of paper, I'm a bloody poet, what do you expect? This is a poem, it's called Trigger Rappy. It's a true story. They said they changed! They said they were reformed! That they'd cast aside the undesirable traits that made people boo and hiss. They hugged huskies. Look at them, this company of rappers. They're trying so hard, trying to win you over with what occasionally passes for thoughtful rhymes and retorts that occasionally raise their heads above the scatological parapet. But tonight I'm going to let you into a little secret. Peer right into their souls. There's something all these Echo. There's something all these MCs have in common, other than an inordinate fondness for dubious hats. Beneath the veneer, what every rapper really wants in those unsung corners of their hearts is a gun. Oh no, they protest. Oh, so distressed. Oh, such comic shock and outrage. The only boom they need is the boom of the bass. Don't need to be packing when they're out on the streets. It's a lie. Ladies and gentlemen, are you trigger happy or are you trigger rappy? No, look, I'm absolutely serious here. You decide, because I know what you say. You don't even own a gun, let alone many guns, would necessitate an entire rack. What are you going to do with a gun rack? But you would, wouldn't you? Give them a chance. You'd have a gun. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to tell you the truth, because the truth is, rappers love guns, guns, guns! Rappers love guns, guns, guns! What are poets like? Quill pens, laudanum perhaps, moments when the clouds of crushing disappointment clear into inspiration. Poets love prevarication, poets love dog-eared old notebooks, poets love ambiguity, poets love weeping into an empty martini glass as the sun sets over the horizon like a spilled box of watercolours. The closest a poet ever gets to a gun is being arrested for using free verse in a sonnet-only area. Rappers love guns, guns, guns! Rappers love guns, guns, guns! The satisfaction of a well-turned rhyme spontaneously uttered from your mouth at just the right moment is a moment of grace, but you yearn for the grip in your hand, the lead shot. Fire, fire, fire! Rappers love guns, guns, guns! Rappers love guns, guns, guns! It's all about flexing your verbal muscles and engaging with a rhythm beyond any which we can match. But in the back of your head, as you a cappella on the stage, there's the click click of a loaded shotgun, the six steady deafening bursts of the magnum, and the sounds weave together and the gun smoke powder burn of your mind. Rappers love guns, guns, guns! Rappers love guns, guns, guns! Even at those romantic moments, when you're near a moment of what you may consider to be ecstasy, your mind drifts to echoes of the shooting range. It is commando, and you are being Schwarzenegger, and your loved one meets your eye with a puzzled glance. But in your head, there are the crescendo of machine guns, AK-47s, behind fluttering, blinking eyes. Rappers love guns, guns, guns! Rappers love guns, guns, guns! Spliff Richard loves guns, guns, guns! Amidst the Bob Marley posters, takes a toke, lies back, and thinks about artillery. Spliff Richard loves guns, guns, guns! John Clark loves guns! John Clark loves cannons, pistols, revolvers, handguns, mortars, rifles, .45s, howitzers, blasters, pieces, flintlock, shooters, muskets, ordnance, firearms, torpedoes, shooting irons, BB guns, Luke, blunderbusses, automatics, clashing of sawn off, semi-automatic is how that ended. Glittering, glowing Gramsci loves feminism and guns. Weeping tears for the oppressed white man everywhere. What? Gramsci, you're gonna have to tell me what your Reddit username is. on his trip around Vietnam, setting these right, making people look a bit more deeply into their souls and how they can so easily dehumanize people around them. Perhaps they should be grateful for Gramsci's insight upon them. And then he takes a trip to a rifle range because, hey, you're in Vietnam, right? And they're given the chance to splash a few extra barton blowing up a cow with a rocket launcher because, hey, you're in Vietnam, right? And he gets the cow in the end of his sights. Gramsci pulls the trigger and the cow says good night. Gramsci hates cows, cows, cows. Gramsci loves guns, guns, guns. Yeah, Adam Feldman. I should have said Moss Prob, should have said Judah Christ. Yeah, Feldman loves guns so much. Just now, backstage, he was looking through his bag for his special rap shoes, and about 12 revolvers fell out. And he was like, sorry, mate, didn't mean to drop all these revolvers all over the floor. I was just looking for lucky shoes. I can't go on stage without lucky shoes. And I would have laughed about the lucky shoes if it wasn't for the alarming presence of a dozen revolvers. Feldman loves guns, guns, guns. Yeah, Ollie, she hasn't come on yet, but she loves guns too. I'll tell you some kind of Shaggy Dog story about it. If I'm honest, I'm a little bit intimidated because I heard she executed a horse with a rifle just the other day. Although I don't look much like a horse, that doesn't mean I'm not a viable target. Holly loves guns, guns, guns. Holly loves guns, guns, guns. Kima, honestly, if you think a poet has a butler or infuses caviar, you need to learn a bit more about how much a poet earns. And, anyway, this is, I was going to talk about Kima for a bit, but you know, to be honest, you get the idea. Let's get back to the chorus, because the clock's ticking. And we all know, don't you, what is it the rappers love? Rappers love guns, guns, guns! Rappers love guns, guns, guns! Call of Duty is a waking dream. You say this is Brighton and it's not that sort of place, but these rappers were shooting rounds through a piece of ham just this afternoon on the seafront. These guys can turn crafts into reservoir dogs given the chance. So don't you go doubting me. It's all right, we're just gonna end now and we're just gonna sing the chorus. And you know how the chorus goes. Rappers love guns, guns, guns. It's the truth. Rappers love guns, guns, guns. We could stage an intervention, but it wouldn't be any good. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Wow. Shouts out to Donald Trump there, loving them guns. Right, next up, we haven't got many girls in the team. We had one. We got another. Would you show some grace, please? For Holly Oster taking the stage.
Hello.
Hello. Right. I'm on their side this year. I promise. I'm going to start by deconstructing your art and its economic historical roots. Then I'll probably just bend over each poet and fuck them with the horrible truth. My rap penis, Trap Wiener, covers you all with metaphorical splooge. Open your posh mouths, I'm about to block vowels. Here, wipe it off with this old towel. There's some on your monocle too. Then I'll probably attempt to fuck Miss Carrick like the rest of my honourable crew. Poetry is the retarded stepbrother of rap. Monosyllabic and basic, dribbling and slack. Mum's like, take your brother to the shop with you, and we're like, okay, damn. If poetry and rap were on a double date, poetry would be the less fit mate that over-explains each anecdote, tells dad jokes and doesn't offer to pay. Meanwhile, rap's got to third base with both of their dates before the starter was eight. Fathered a bastard with half of the staff in the place, laughed and awayed. The elitist tones from the Guardian reading yeast infection loaf of bleeding heart liberal bleating clones has risen poetry from its tomb back into the recent news with Kate Tempest's endless YouTube views. It's insipid and privileged, that's why you lose. Because Kate's just a rapper who lacks for a tune. You're just vacuous toffs who enrapture the posh with your easy and tedious vacuum of tosh. We are activists. You're just the grammar school nerds who we used to shot 20-pound bags of mixed herbs. you emphatically burned in the scullery, probably, are on these poets like their daddy's own property. Oi, Lawley. You look like a pub quiz fan. An RE teacher who plays keyboard in a Christian rock band. Or at worst, a cult leader. Baby skull eater. Prison missionary sodomite godogram. Michael Parker just looks like a proper dad. The kind of dad us rappers dream of while ours is in prison for assaulting our nan. And Rosie is a feminist until there's half a gram of shit shine. This guy looks like a Comic-Con virgin's version of Wolverine. Which makes Clarky the hot one of the team. Housewife's choice, poetry's Justin Bieber. Vanilla as icing, the moistest wet dream on the habitat sheets of your boyhood esteems. Your cars, we're Toy Story 3.
To me, Lord, what fools these mortals be. Welcome to the stage, William Shakespeare and me. That's right, your band of brothers had a plentiful lack of wit, as the Bard of Avon might have put it. I'd some of English literature's top quotes. You had Tenchu's homophobic knob jokes. If this be battle of wits, Shakespeare will win it. Though this is madness, yet there is method in it. Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. I'm channeling the dissing of 400 years. I'm Julius Caesar. I am Hamlet. I am Romeo. I'm the whips and scorns of time. Now here's the second folio. Alas. Poor Tenchu.
Oh, yes.
So-called master of rhyme. His shit was bad, unreconstructed grime. He rapped about his magic pound of flesh. The Brighton crowd were sadly unimpressed. Poor player, he frets and struts his hour upon the stage, and then, if you will, is heard no more. But friends, rappers, come, dream. What is your fate to be or not to be? Rick, yours is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing. But I jest, it's just I like to say things wisely and slow. They stumble that run fast. I want to go at the pace and the rhythm and the flow that I feel. I don't feel your need for speed. You think you need some sensual freedom, some poetry. Call it Renaissance, call it romantic, call it beat. A rose by any other name would smell as sweet. And John, you speak an infinite deal of nothing. Some are born great, some achieve greatness, and some have greatness thrust upon them, and some get scurrying to rhyming dictionaries. You scullion, you rampallion, you fustilarian, you're worrying that my Falstaffian jibes are justly scary, and I'll tickle your catastrophe. I'll give you an analogy, go get thee to a nunnery, go. And Holly, shall I compare thee to a summer's day? No.
You mean full of cocodamol and...
Kemma! Where are you? Kemma's tree! Oh, go prick thy face and overread thy fear, thou lily-livered boy. A weasel hath not such a deal of spleen as you are tossed with. Thou hast in thy skull no more brain than I have in my elbow. You grunt and sweat under a weary life. Thou wretched, rash, intruding fool, farewell. Cease this toil and, I don't know, shuffle off this mortal coil. Ed, brevity is the soul of wit. Adam, Judicrus, Most Prob, Felman, your rap names are absurd. I could a tale unfold whose lightest word would arrow up thy soul. Freeze. What if this show was just called MCs? I mean, who even calls you that these days anyway? Your words are so soon defunct, but I've had the funk for 400 years. I know the rhythm, every move, the movements and music of the spheres. Sometimes a thousand twangling instruments will hum about mine ears. Oh, Shakespeare, you taught me language. And my profit on it is that I know how to curse. Fie on you! Thou art a boil, a plague sore, an embossed carbuncle, thou mad mustachio purple-hued malt worms, base dunghill villains, thou thing of no bowels, thou clay-brained guts, thou knotty-pated fool, thou whoreson, obscene tallow-catch, puke-stocking, caddis-dark garter, you bolting hutch of beastliness, you swollen parcel of dropsies, you huge bombard of sack, you stuffed cloak-bag of guts, you eel skin, you bull's pizzle, you sheath.
Yeah.
You waste my time, now doth time waste me. My revels now are ended, the rest is silence.
Yo.
It's not quite silence. And next up, we have the offended. And I'm sure he's got a thing to say. Spliff Richard.
Hey, morning. Hey. You can probably tell I fucking love this event. I'm so stoked to live in a place that has this. This is a monstrosity of a thing. Thank you for making it happen. Thank you for being here. Thank you. I'm going to get to it because we're running a little slack. I was debating tonight. I was going to go for a bit of cheap call and response in my rhyme, but then I wasn't sure whether to do it or not. But at the top of the show, Rosie expressed a displeasure and that sort of thing. So let's go with it. It's going to be... Sorry, that's cheap. There's going to be a line later on, unlike Dead Prez, you are not bigger than hip-hop. And if you could come in with, like, bigger than hip-hop on that bit, that would be fucking amazing. But if it lands, it might not land, but if it lands, try not to lose your shit because it's going to keep flowing straight after it. Thank you. Unlike Dead Prez, you are not bigger than hip-hop. Alright, here we go. See, last year, who's going to come up on it? Last year, perhaps with the exception of Rosie, things between the two teams seemed to get a little cozy, and perhaps a touch too tame to me, but it seems plain to me that's not really what people came to see. So now you're going to taste the difference just like Sainsbury's. This year, this here, is a whole other type of party. Shit is getting really nasty. Y'all are getting fucked so bad you're going to need Pilates. Because then you may call me a heathen. But if I wanted a civilised, sanitised, circle-jerking exercise, I'd just go to a poetry evening. Because when Miss Carrick got up here and spat both the bars into Barbaric and tore me apart, that was the most heart I've seen from that team since I can remember. And yeah, I got somewhat dismembered, but I just got to stop and tell you this. You made a good ally, you make a fucking great nemesis. And yeah, I was tempted to come back with more of the same, calling your names and giving you all kinds of hell, but I'm just not that kind of rhymer. Don't need to stoop to that level to undermine you. I'll just let the results speak for themselves and ask you kindly to remind me, because this stone of memory span can be so unforgiving. Wasn't the year that you dropped me the same year you stopped winning? That's why I never stopped grinning, because every time Every time you people come chatting the same shit about Spliff Rick. He smokes too much and he talks too quick. Well, even if I am just a bumbling stoner crippled by his addiction, even if sometimes when I rhyme I get so hyped it gives me bad diction, if that's an accurate description, how is that reflecting on you? Because make no mistake, I am baked as a capist. I'm perfecting your dissecting and shoveling disrespect on you, putting a sweat on you as I turn the heat up. I don't smoke this much for my benefit, so you fucking degenerates can have a chance to keep up. And yeah, getting left off the team. It was a bit of a knock to my self-esteem, but things ain't always what they seem. Never dream what a blessing it would turn out to be. So no anyone who doubted me, disappointed is what you're about to be. Cause this here, freak of nature, like Frankenstein's monster is back to haunt his creators. I am a mutant. DNA from both sides of this divide resides inside me and provides me with unique insight in how to take them down and be done with them. I know how these bastards think. I used to be one of them. But I gave the Dr. Jekyll and me quite the hiding. And now there ain't no hiding from this monstrous metamorphosis. Cast off the dead skin, release the beast within, and you best be sure I got more of this, because anyone who thinks you can win is just speaking out the wrong orifice. Because some days are your day, but today is just not one. For you, I guarantee this will be not fun. So if, like me, you can see and agree that Team MC gets the job done, when the let's have some fun, so open up your lungs and let me hear your voice if you got one! Yeah! Because we got flows! But everybody here knows that you got none. And at the close of the show, I suppose all the faces of those will be crosser than hot buns, and more miserable than Morrissey. Maybe surrender would be the most pertinent policy. Because let's look at this honestly, when I get done, which one of you fucks wants to follow me? None of you probably, because we do this properly. Put your hands in the air because this is a robbery. We're stealing the victory, leave you in poverty, because a win tonight is our rightful property. Like Julius Caesar, we bring in the Vini Vidi, and you know soon come the Vici. You and we are a whole different species. Watching you against us in action is like Jeremy Kyle battling Jeremy Paxman. You are an insignificant line of dots, and we are Pac-Man. You couldn't be worse off if we were all US cops and you were an unarmed black man. And speaking of... Speaking of the race card, you know I hate to use it. I don't want to sound monotone, but every year your team is so monochrome it makes UKIP look inclusive. And the only way I can deduce it, the way I deduce it, there's only two possible explanations. Either you ain't repping your art form, or poetry and writing is just for Caucasians. And yeah, I know it must be jarring, but what feels like a title fight for you, for us, is just sparring. Knocking you around this stage helps us keeping trim like a trip to the gym, tramping underfoot like a treadmill. How on earth did you get your head filled with the delusion that you could compete with us? Go sit at the kids' table, you're not able to eat with us, but still you will get served tonight down here by the sea. Here comes the line, just like this was a chip shop, because unlike Dead Prez, you are not bigger than hip-hop. You couldn't catch us if you were cruising in Concord and we were jogging in flip-flops, because if words were wealth, you lot couldn't afford a piss pot. But we are the A-game bringers, unsuitable for beginners. When comes the crunch time, we got the punchlines that can feed a whole KFC at lunchtime, because you know we're serving up zingers. Wordplay by the bundle. We're somewhere high over the rainbow with George Jeffrey, Zippy and Bungle. The only weed that's left for you is the kind that tumbles. Float like butter, sting like bumble. You are not ready to rumble. Smack the iPhone out of your hand and turn it into apple crumble. The only dessert that's left for you is the pie that's humble. But now it's too late to quit. This fuse has been lit. We dynamite in Napoleon, so prepare to face your Waterloo. The last thing I saw that stank as bad as you was a Glastonbury Portaloo. Reading off your fucking pieces of paper like some chump with an auto cue. So people of the Concord, when comes time to vote with your throat, I think you all know what you ought to do. And later on we can all look back on YouTube and see how bad we slaughtered you. Yeah.
Mr. Spliff, I'm about to push you off a lyrical cliff because I could see in people's eyes they started to drift, and yes, their eyes, they started to shift. So, I'm going to take you on a little memoir first, and it will get somewhere, I promise. Okay. I wanted this to be a scroll, but so pretend that it is. My toes are dipped in the blue, my eyes soaking in the new. I found myself here in Brighton, a place where I can make poetry, rap, and music, have a creative threesome, letting them be beautiful, strange creatures I can set free within this vibrant city. Making up stories in the garden with my brother and sister was how my pen first met paper. I was amazed that when my lips parted and I let my imagination loose, people just might want to listen for a bit. And fairies. I was fascinated. Poems about fairies, reading poems about fairies, reading poems under flower pots. I loved it. And so the fairy fables took their tale, and then rhymes soon took their place. And before I knew it, my riddles were the soundtrack to every friendship group I was in at school. I wrote every anthem of every bad breath teacher you could imagine. The ballads of the bullies were no match for the similes from my speech. Made up on the spot and ready any day of the week, I was speaking 10-year-old beat poetry over the top of 80s smash hits. I was a cool 10-year-old. Living on a prayer for new romances in the playground and shot to the heart for breakups. Wearing words like a warrior call, singing sounds that would pick people up from their fall for the love of filling things with words. Notepads, school desks, toilet doors, and rooms full of extraordinary people with ears that are hungry to chew on sounds. That's what I love to do. Fill things. I'm a filler. And I don't know about you guys, but I'm feeling full, but a bit bloated. A little bit dodgy curry, kind of bloated. One that no MC Miller Lite would fix. Because I can't hack the whack rap, full of snapbacks and the back chat about crap. Superficial, self-indulgent, make love with the brand of my trousers type. Another vehicle to heave the waste of materialistic hype. Like the abandoned carriages on trains that carry nuclear waste. Whack rap moves across the music industry at a polluting, dragging pace. In fact, whack rap is deceiving, like a bird with plastic feathers. It seems kind of nice, but can't support itself in flight. Looks sort of tacky and smells like shite. Rap, you truly are the little girl with a curl in the middle of her forehead. When it's good, it is very, very good, and when it is bad, it is just plain horrid. But this is Brighton. This place is different. Full of different poets and full of different rappers. And right now, to the poets, I'd probably sound crackers, so I'm about to add some cheese because I feel this release that starts to tease between my teeth, the feeling from my chest that pulls down beneath, that reminds me of my young self's lyrical belief. I've got something to confess. I am a rapper and my heart at best. I can't slate my trade, not for the poetry parade, but give me a second, please let me explain. See, Rosie and Michael kindly asked me to be a fellow poet. I answered yes before I could throw it, feeling tense. I thought, what an opportunity to perform at this event, but then I realised there were disses to invent. I picked up the pen and ended up just chewing. This kind of rap is my heart. I thought, what am I doing? Believe me, I tried. I even cried a bit. But when I rap with these guys, my heart starts to flip like a vocal gymnastic class. I've never met a bunch of people so enthusiastic about the way they pass words and for the positive. What can I say, guys? I guess I'm just not monogamous. Sometimes I'm a hyperpolling hippopotamus, and other times I'm a rhyming rhinoceros. But rapping is like reaching into the mind with binoculars, and I just love to take a peek in through a freestyle, a chance to refill your mind for the words. It's just absurd, and I feel it, it burns. It's like a flame, it's insane, and I move through the name. This is where I go, and I stay the same. And it came up with a box to beat. I feel it in my mind, and I feel the fleet. It's as though it's buzzing out from the street, cause what these guys do is just not credited. They speak with words, it's not edited, they don't rehearse. They speak with a mind that is just a thirst. Look at his tooth, look at his teeth, as it moves underneath, he starts to creep. He's moving from the sweep with his eyes. Yes, he's in disguise, I can tell by the way he hops. Look at this guy, yes, I must know I'm a rapper at best. Rap is my song, I must confess.
Alright, ladies and gents. There's not a lot of commentary I want to give on what's been said previously. I just know that when I first came here, even before I moved, someone told me that Brighton stood for something. What they told me it stood for was be right on, right? It sounds cheesy as shit, but it's true. Like, you talk to people here, they think differently about people in other spots that you encounter, and that's one of the reasons I've been here for like near 20 years. Now, one thing I know is equality starts now. That's all I say. So, once upon a time, back in the course of history, the poets could be sure to win the moral victory. But Rosie versus Rick was like the swing of the pendulum.
He's probably too impotent from weed to fuck anyone.
Now come on, imagine if he slandered back her lady garden, what would have happened? Double standards, moral compass facing backwards. Does it matter after all? He's
only a male rapper.
A sexist freestyle we would never get away with. But Rosie Carrick took a year to premeditate it. It was riddled with more holes than a donut baker's at the ozone layer.
Check your own behavior.
But Rosie ain't the only one to call to account. Verity started well, but let it fall to the ground. See, at first she battled language that is keeping us captive and corralling how we think and making sheep of the masses, saying
fuck all competition forever.
Connect the alternating currents just like Nikola Tesla. We called the ceasefire, it was spoken sincerely. Then drunkenly she shouted, but the poets won, really? Double standards is not a tough call. I mean, how much are the poets' words worth?
Fuck all.
Cause all they got is words and they are walking contradictions, so the poets are
fuck all competition.
So you must choose. Suburban is subdued or more original than what the world is up to. Fuck you, we're fighting for the psyche of the city. We're fighting for the psyche of the city, you must choose. Cause it's becoming a blood feud, the whole tree of etymology I will uproot. Fuck you, we're fighting for the psyche of the city. We love you, but we're fighting for the psyche of the city. Now, once upon a time, back in the course of history, Michael Parker tried to criticize our authenticity. He brought up,
when you ask for three things from the audience,
a freeform performed since before the Victorians. A psychic interaction they get nowhere near. He suggested that it meant I lacked my own ideas. Pfft, a crude effort, because I knew he knew better. He's been learning freestyle with Hines at the Youth Center. Double standards, it cannot be helped. When battling rappers, what, you don't become a rapper yourself? You took the bait and stumbled straight into our poised bear trap. Mike, you stare into the void and the void stares back. Your poetry is saccharine and just too nice, but when you freestyle,
I'm gonna beat the fuck out of you guys. Gonna beat the fuck out of you guys.
Double standards, that's why we spout freeze. Cause from the overflow of the heart, the mouth speaks. Still they're reading from sheets, sorry security blankets, asking us to slow it down as if they're learning the language. Your poetry in schools, kiddies pull a blank face. Damn straight, I find myself having to translate. Bottom line, their communication sucks balls. How much are the poets' words worth?
Fuck all.
Cause all they got is words and they're a walking contradiction, so the poets are
fuck all competition.
So you must choose. Suburban is subdued or more indicative of what the world is up to. Fuck you, we're fighting for the psyche of the city. We're fighting for the psyche of the city. You must choose, cause it's becoming in a blood feud, the whole tree of etymology I will uproot. Fuck you, we're fighting for the psyche of the city. We love you, but we're fighting for the psyche of the city. Say it. Double standards, double standards, double standards, double standards. This might take the piss like a Portaloo cubicle, but well, at least I made the poet sound musical.
I'd like to do that. This is a love poem. Hey, no, but, I'm gonna need some help.
Wah-hoo!
Oh, I'm glad you asked. Now then.
War is good, war is great, it's hate that I appreciate. I need bloody bloodshed to satisfy my hunger. Keep your iron and your fish, it's war I like to monger. Now, listen to teacher, all you history nerds, because it's time for a lesson in the war of the words.
Still, the poets and MCs continue to babble on with battles going back before the fall of Babylon to languish and language war forevermore. And in 1642, they entered an English civil war. Carrick Spears led the Cavaliers through all seasons, and John Clark led the Roundheads for, well, obvious reasons. When Mr. Spliff Turncoat, Mr. Get High, Smoke Trees, Son, fled to the other side and committed high treason, the spoken heard charge, and the poets all dreaded the fate of King Charles was where they'd be headed. But the poets had more lines, and you can shake a spear at more bars than the Tower of London. You hear that? Blood drenches, but our thirst never quenches. And years later, both sides took to the trenches. General Gramsci, we must quit. We have no plan. We must quit. Oh, just freestyle. It's the same as having put thought into it. Oh. 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 No, no. Very, 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 very good, sir. Very good. Your dedication is perennial. We'll just keep what we say very vague and general. But their improvisation tactics failed to clear a path. To cut a long story short, they'd snip war and peace in half. And if one world war isn't enough for you, coming at you the sound of World War II. Attack from all angles like some MC Escher shit, but the MC spat messy shit and got shot down like Messerschmitt. And who shot them down when they were flying so high? It was the poets who spit fire in the sky. Sorry, no, sir, sorry, I'd just like to raise a question. Surely your biased teachings are misguided. I mean, Hitler's a poet, is that not worth a mention? Well, history's written by the victors, so fuck off, detention. 1964! The rappers flew like vultures, attacking what they saw as a bygone culture. It's guerrilla warfare, how could either side prevail? It's a bumpy road, it's the Ho Chi Minh Braille. But the MCs just couldn't let bygones be bygones. Like the US couldn't let Saigons be Saigons. And so Viet Cong turned to Soviet Pong, want a pickle, and hammer and tongue clashed with the hammer and the sickle. Our floor is so cold, with our iron fist we'll crush ya. Your only superpower is Cold War Russia. Let's have a propaganda at their propaganda trail. All hail General Feldman, front page of the Daily Mail. What's that? No, what's that? What, Red Scare? No, they're just a red square, I swear. They tank so bad, they're Tiananmen Square. They put the Bolshevik in Bolshevik, they make us sick. And the word dictator, they stick the dick, the slick-grating, dictating, dictating fools. Let me break it down for you like the Berlin Wall. Now, Mother Russia, like old Mother Hip-Hop, a shadow of its former self, must flip-flop. Its leaders feign liberalism and use it as a bandage to cloak its inherent misogyny through more creative language. For certain, it's iron curtains, it's time to concede. And Spliff, I thought communists were meant to share their weed. I mean, throughout all of history, there's no one dopier. His rhymes have less class than a Marxist utopia. This war will last an entire age. Each battle will have its own Wikipedia page. Yes, young man, what on earth is it? Sorry, sir, I'd just like to revisit. I mean, hip-hop can be a voice for the voices in distress, and this is a voice that you're trying to oppress. Surely that has more in common with an evil Russian. Well, history's written by victors, so end of discussion. Weapons of mass obstruction in every rapper's syllables to constantly justify. They're all forward-thinking liberals. Jesus, we get it. Hip-hop's moved on. Christ, let me see. I didn't even think Blair was as labored with his I'm not a dick legacy. This war will last forever and a day. It began a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. MCs reinvent poetry to prove they're more than equals. So I guess that makes poetry classics and you guys like prequels. If we've learned one thing from history, it's that Jar Jar Binks is so funny, isn't he? Deary me, but no, I'll let Qui-Gons be Qui-Gons now, and I'll tell the truth. I think there has been enough shots fired underneath this roof. I'll drop the act and be honest with this final feature. After all, hip-hop can clearly be a far greater teacher. Ed, you are a true gentleman with whom I'd hate to brawl, and it was an honour serving with you at the Battle of Albert Hall. John, it's a pleasure to hear you tear it up like tissues. With your help, I just might resolve my daddy issues. Using one art form to attack another seems to me an ironic error, like calling a war civil or, I don't know, declaring war on terror. It's but I don't know. Can he say that? But
In the real world, it's painfully clear that conflict is yet to yield when a concert hall can become a real-life battlefield. So before we head back out there into the real world, at the end of this piece, it seems far more better to promote a message of peace. I mean, a ceasefire leaves no side bereft, and the war doesn't decide who's right, only who's left. So we shall not fight. Instead, we shall love. And we shall go on to the end. We shall love in France. We shall love in the skies. We shall love with growing confidence in the seas and the oceans. We shall love in the landing grounds. We shall love in the hills. And we shall love on the beaches. And we shall never surrender! Because absolutely nothing. Class dismissed.
Honestly, guys, we're getting so much shit from the place. We need to get out of here, really. Have you had a good evening?
Entertained.
Do you know what I love about Poets vs MCs? MCs, yeah!
Do you know what I love about Poets vs MCs? Poets! Everybody, we gotta go. We gotta get up the stage right now.
We gotta go.
Make some noise and get the
fuck
out.
Please make lots and lots of noise.